happen now. Let me make sure. Get my Twitch creator dashboard up and see. It says, you're live. All right. And it's funny because I know everybody coming in going, wait, where's Bandit at? And I was like, well, him Smeepy. I got, let's see, I got the tits going, I got Twitch stuff, I got the redeems set back up. Turn the game on in just a moment and I'll broadcast it so you can see. But trying to think, what was the last thing we did? We started Leon's A campaign, right? And we did a little bit of stuff, I think.
I don't know. Did we get it started?
Maybe we did.
We just end right at the, I think you might have ended because you were like right there at the end and you're like, oh, is this a good place to stop? And you're like, you're right here at the end. You just might as well just power through it.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. So we'll officially start Leon's A campaign because we did Claire A, Leon B. Now we'll do Leon A, Claire B, and then we can mess with the bonus games when we get done with the main thing, and then I'll get OGRE3 some way, and then we can go through that, the three of us together. It'll be a grand old time. I get to revisit my favorite stomping grounds. Not that I haven't enjoyed this, it's just, you know, you for you, 2 was the iconic and most beloved. 2 was my first. Then I went back to 1. Then I played 3, and I loved 3 to death, especially because it's like, kind of like with 2, it's like, oh, you could have multiple, like, playthroughs, multiple endings, stuff like that. This is so cool. Like, I kind of wish most of Resident Evils were like that, but I guess if they were, you know, it would make these lesser in some capacity, but, you know, it's, I'm just glad GOG has been releasing the originals. I just wish Twitch wasn't so stupid about the cutscenes. Streaming, yeah. Like I hate that so much. It makes me so mad. I just want to go.
You're real stupid.
They're so stupid. I'm gonna smack them. Just go.
And it's not like there's any kind of copyrighted material. You're already playing the game. So yep. Why is the cutscene blacked out?
No, oh, that kills me, man. Also, hey Nacho, good to see you.
Nacho.
Nacho. Like, it kills me, like, when I was streaming Xenoverse a while back, which I need to go through those games, whether it blocks the cutscenes or not, but it always pisses me off when it blocks important cutscenes. I'm like, these games are old. People know what happens, and people know the story of Dragon Ball. Bandit may join us. He is, he was napping last we saw, because he, let me see what he said, just got back from an 8-hour dinner theater adventure. I'm going to set an alarm, but I might not be alive. That was at 2:29. So he had a big shindig thing happen, and it's kind of like in the past. He gave me the go-ahead, me and Finn the go-ahead. If we wanted to go through RE2, we can. If he wakes up, he can join us. And yeah, I mean, I'm glad he went out and had fun, you know, did the thing. You know, because he doesn't get vacation very often, from what I understand, so he's had time off, and he's trying to take advantage of it, but I know it's like he wanted to stream, but I keep checking, and I think he ends up sleeping through the days he's off, and again, as somebody who, I get home from work, and usually I eat lunch and have a fat nap, I understand how that feels just tremendously.
A fat nap.
We a fat fucking nap, yeah. I'm fat, we know that. Why was that Yankee Doodle Dandy pull the plug? I found out one of the new coworkers through my team lead apparently loves Metalocalypse, and he's like, you should just, next time you get a chance to talk to him, just throw out one of the voices. And I'm like, it's very tempting to do, just be like, oh, hey, I have a question. Come here. I need your help with something real quick. Just come over here. I need to talk to you, you know. And just see if he recognizes the fucking murder face voice.
Oh my god, is that body bag?
Oh, hey, body bag. Hello, idiot. I'll get rid of body bag, but I'm not getting rid of Quado. Stupid
Quado
shit.
Quado stays.
That's Quado stays. Don't buy booze. That ain't food. What do you mean booze ain't food?
I'd rather chop off my ding dong than admit Boozy food.
Oh, wowee. You'd rather chop off your ding dongs than admit the Boozy food? Yeah! Oh.
Look, you buys ladies tampons.
Ah, Toki is ladies. He has tampons in his basket. Yours, Lady Squizzle. No, I'm not!
No, not!
He got so pissed so fast. He pissed. Yeah, I think out of all of them, the Murderface one is my best one now. It used to be Nathan, but I end up throwing the Murderface out more because it makes people laugh because he's just such a piece of shit. Like, you can't help but laugh at him and how he talks. And finding out, like, in that one episode that they basically take all of the bass tracks and remove them from their songs. Or when they go live, they unplug his mic or his amp on purpose so they don't, you know, his bass is not audible, which... Oh. Which is a nod to something real that happened. Apparently, in Metallica's early days, they had a member who, in one of their albums, Lars Ulrich being the asshole he is, basically removed the bass track.
Oh my god.
So the drums could be heard better. And I'm like, fuck you, dude. The drums could be heard fine. You're just being an asshole. Need to refresh this here. Oh yeah, Lars is a piece of shit, apparently. It's sad, but... what can you do? I'm checking my thing. It says my average stream bitrate is too high. What the hell are you talking about? Oh, well. But, yeah, we're going to give Bandit a little bit, and then we're just going to jump right into it. And also, just try to give people time to pop by the stream, because it's, you know, we've only been live for 6 minutes. Hey, George, how you doing? Good to see you.
George.
I wonder if this...
I can't get too much because I gave him a lot of shit Friday.
Uh-oh, what'd you do?
Just the normal. Just giving George a hard time.
Oh, so you were trying to purposely kill him for comedic effect?
No, I was trying to kill everybody, but, you know.
I mean, yeah, that's fair. I mean, I fondly remember the, you know, games of the past, which the Inuyasha one, where it's like, yeah, y'all could die any moment, and I'm like, oh boy.
We only do it because you know you can take it, George. We love you still.
Yeah, yeah, you're a tough and awesome, you know, compadre. I'm trying to think. I know we said at one point we were gonna, like, for shits and giggles, do like the arrange mode to just get Brad to get the costumes and shit. But I guess we can still do like a normal run for this one, because I think because of how the GOG thing is set up, we have to open the Leon campaign separate thingy, make save or so. It's so weird. See, listen, as friends, we know where the line is. Yeah, we know. Oh,
I think
also,
you actually got that little preview at the end of last game, because when you stopped and when the credits finally finished, it was like, "Hey, you can do this run through now, and if you don't pick up any items, you can meet Brad."
Yep, we can meet old B-Rad and try to murder him and get the key for the special outfits. Which, I'm like, I wonder if you can just do a range mode and just do that. That way, you don't have to pick up any ammo, because I know he's not.
Totally.
He's not an easy zombie to kill, unfortunately, which it's... Do we know why in 3? Because he's infected with the T-Virus, and then he gets killed by Nemesis, so it kind of infects him even further, so he kind of just becomes a super zombie in a way.
Oh, yeah. I don't know if you can do it on a ranged mode.
Well, we can find out. Also, real quick, I need to get the... let me get the link for my Donothon thing to put it up here.
Mm-hmm.
Won't take me but a second, because I've got the counter. We're at 46%, which I did the calculations. That means we're at like $736, which is wonderful, because that's $736 that I ultimately can use to help for this thing. Because when I went to the dentist the other day, thankfully he said that the fillings aren't deteriorating, it's just they need to be replaced because they've been there a while. and there's still time, so I don't have to rush this. But if I could just get it done, I will be more than happy, because that's one less thing to worry about. I hate having to dip into my savings for things sometimes, because bills and shit do not make it easy. Next time I get paid, I just go back to it. But, and I gotta remind people, or look through the list and see who all donated, but it's like, if people donate at least $50, they can request a voice line for me as a certain character, you know, whatever, because that was a thing that Noe came up with. So, I'm gonna honor the deal, I just gotta look through it and see who it was. And I know I think at the 700 thing, there was a voice actor Yap Fest, so I've gotta just, like, find a day where I can borrow this computer from Lady and just get some friends together and just stream and just chew the fat and talk about voice acting and how awesome it is and how I love it and how I want to be in it and how I've been blessed to have a few opportunities here and there, like the recent thing, my friend Twig and other friends that and their D&D thing for Curse of Strahd. I got to record some lines for them reading a letter, so I was happy about that. And yeah, did you get to see that?
I did not.
Okay, well, I can send you the exact scene, but they are on YouTube and Twitter and everything is Vibecheck D&D. But while I'm thinking about it, I'm on Lady's computer, I don't have access to the file, but I can easily, at some point, I can just send you the file or just give you the episode. Because it's a good episode. They're basically recording their sessions, and then somebody is animating them and stuff. And then they got to a part where this letter was being read by one of the party members, and it shifted to me reading it. And it was the burgomaster of the village or whatever, talking about Strahd and all the bullshit he was doing. And it was fun. I even had somebody come by my stream a couple days ago, said, "Oh, hey, you're the person that was involved with Twig's thing. You read the letter and stuff. You're really cool. I'm gonna follow you." And I'm like, "Aw, thank you."
Fame.
Huh?
Fame.
Fame. You never know. I hold out hope that I can somehow break into the industry and get into at least something. I don't care if it's a bit part, just so I can be like, "I'm a part of that. Yay. The Burgermaster makes a mean burger." I mean, my Burgermaster would, yeah. That says here somebody supported me. Hold on. I got the email notification, but it doesn't tell me how much and who did it, so I have to open it. Fighting the robot. Hey there, Lux. How you doing? It's good to see you. It's been a hot minute. You doing okay? Oh, George, thank you. I appreciate that. I will look at your stuff and see what happens, but every little bit helps. I don't care if it's like a couple bucks, however much. Every little bit helps and gets me closer to getting these fillings taken care of. As long as I can do the dentist stuff, I can then move to getting new glasses, because these glasses I've had for a while, they're my only pair. And then, like, a few weeks ago at work, I was handling a big-ass box, and it smashed me in the face and bent my glasses just a little bit. Not enough to where it's, like, horrible on my vision, but just enough to kind of annoy me because I can see where the bend is. So, see, mom's doing better too. I'm glad to hear that, and I'm glad you're okay. And it's, again, good to see you. Bandit's supposed to be here, but he's also probably very tired. So I'm going to keep his name in the stream title because he could pop in the voice chat at any moment and hang out with us. Use any, they have cheap frames. I may have to look into that because I just need to see if my stupid workplace's insurance can help me with that. Because it's also been a hot minute since I went to an eye doctor, and my prescription is in my home state, so I don't know. I'm going to bully Bandit soon. I'm sure he will enjoy that. All right.
I'll totally echo what Lux said and say use Zenny, because mm-hmm. I use them too. I got two pairs of prescription strength glasses. That, like, mm-hmm. all you got to do is go on their website and mm-hmm. you know, you put in your information, like your specs for your prescription. And I got two pairs of glasses for like $120.
Oh shit!
Yeah, exactly. You get to pick out your frames and everything. It's really good.
Oh damn! Well, Well, I'm pretty sure my prescription back home is the same because it's my the doctor when I went to the eye doctor all those years ago, he said, "Look, your vision's plateaued. You're not going to get any better or worse. You're kind of just you're there." So I don't think my prescription has changed, but I could go to an eye doctor and just get a new prescription and then see about this place because I'll have to get the website and look it up because I could desperately use some new glasses. But let's see, I got a new character he'll like in new art. 12-foot tall woman and trans Russian polar bear MILF. That sounds pretty cool, actually. 12-foot tall monster woman. We like giant ladies around here for sure. And hey there, Shao. Good to see you. Only makes it better. Yeah, honestly. All right, so I'm going to start the game up, and I will try to broadcast it to Finn here. So give me just a moment, everybody. We've gone about 15 minutes. Again, Bandit may show up, or he may just be resting. I'm not going to bother him because he did have some kind of adventure earlier, and it's his vacation week, essentially. And, you know, most people know his job is horrible. So he's probably catching up on much-needed rest. Let's see. Lady D awoke the whole internet to their job. I mean, before Lady D, I've always enjoyed the women of various sizes, you know, not going to hide it or deny it. But, yeah. She's based on a Minecraft warden, so smooth face about her and wide mouth, making her one of my few monstrous characters. Okay. Still, sounds awesome. Too far away from the screen, I can't see shit. Well, y'all know whenever I get the loose glasses, I can't see a goddamn thing. You know, everybody probably knows by now, but, you know, when I was born, the muscles in your eyes that focus and actually try to give a shit about stuff apparently said, "Nah, homie, we got, hey, if you want to show me, that's fine." It's like, "Hey, no, you got blindness on both sides of your family? Nah, you're going to be lucky to see, homie. We're not going to totally blind you. The muscles aren't going to develop worse shit, but young you's not going to know anything. You're not going to complain." So it's not going to be till like first or second grade to where your teachers go, "Yeah, your kid needs glasses." Like, I literally went through kindergarten in a couple grades before it's like, "Yeah, he kind of needs glasses." And, you know, I don't fault my family because, you know, again, I didn't complain. You know, the kid me just thought everything was blurry unless it was up in my face. You know, didn't know no better. All right.
Eyes are supposed to work?
Yeah. Yeah, that's how it felt when I put on glasses for the first time. I vividly think young me was like, "Hey, wait a minute. This is how it's supposed to be? None of the fuck."
Put on glasses and immediately, a whole new world.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, hold on. I gotta plug in the controller and then use it to start things, otherwise it won't register it. Controller, why you do this to me? Okay, hold on. I gotta turn the damn game off and plug the controller in first. Hold on. So finicky. Let's see. I had hypermetropy when I was younger. Then went away for like 20 years and now my eyes are giving up. Also, you need to plug the bastard in before you start the game. Or won't pick up. Yeah. Like, Bast recommended a great controller. But, no, the controller you gave me, it finally just kaputskied on me, George. I'm letting it rest. And then I found this one that Bast recommended to me. That apparently you gotta plug in first before the game boots up. So now I know now. I've still got it. I didn't throw it away. It still works enough. It's just, it's gotten to the point where, like, the cable and stuff, just if it moves too far one way, it shuts off. I will not just throw it away because it was a gift from a friend. Okay, trying this again.
Well, if it finally dies, you could always just give it a Viking funeral in George's honor.
Yeah.
Put it on a little boat and light it on fire. Send it to Game Controller Valhalla.
Valhalla. Alright, game is up. I'm gonna broadcast to you, homie. Hold on. Oh, I'm being raided. Thank you for the raid, Goldie. Hello. Thank you, Trashfish Raid. Good to see you. How you doing? I was lurking in your chat. I see you've raided me. I appreciate that. Hello and welcome to you and your raiders. For those you don't know who I am, my name is Soulstone. You can call me Soul. You can also call me Dadbot, Robodad, Mecha Papa, you know, all that kind of stuff. I'm getting more monikers as time goes on. And I am a sometimes robot PNG tuber, Dadbot of the YouTuber community, and I'm fixing to start playing OGRE2. And tonight I'm joined, normally I'm joined by my friend Bandit, but I think he's sleeping, he's very tired.
I just needed you to know. I love you.
Alistair Red, thank you for following, I appreciate that. And but tonight I'm still joined by a fantastic friend of mine, a kick-ass kaiju by the name of Finn.
I'm here to eat cities and disable governments, and I'm all out of cities.
There you go. See, Bandit would be proud of that. Also, thank you for shouting out Goldie Nacho. I appreciate you. But yeah, you were kicking ass in Dead Space, and I hope you were having a good time. Real quick, I need to check on something. Ooh. Since you raided me. I need to pass the love on to somebody else. I try to lurk in people's streams while I'm streaming, because I'm trying to be supportive like that. Let's see. Hold on. Funny thing, I'm playing Destiny 2 right now. Nice. Yeah, I've got that as my follow sound. I haven't really found a follow sound. I haven't looked, but maybe one day I'll get, you know, my more unique follow sound of some type. I'd love to have something more unique. Let's see. Oh, here we go. I can lurk in this friend's stream. Oh, hell yeah. Dead Space is great. I need to go through them one day myself. We could probably get you to join me and maybe Bandit as well.
I will never forget trying to play it for the first time on nightmare mode because somebody thought that was a good idea.
Wait, was it me?
No.
It was okay. Daniel. Okay, I was double checking. It's like, okay.
We were at your house, though.
Yeah, yeah. I was about to say, it feels like I was involved somehow. I'm just double checking.
It was dark, and we thought it was a great idea to all just boot that up, turn it up really loud because we were home alone.
And oh boy, did
the first enemy killed us all, or killed everybody, because it's so hard.
We got so scaled. Let's see. The Dead Space remake is awesome. I kind of hope they remake the second one. Let's see. Soulstone, a.k.a. Primus, a.k.a. Dadbot, a.k.a. Mecha Papa, a.k.a. Chungus McShiny, a.k.a. the Clubberburr ass lady. Soul, I'm going to send you a video Bandit when he finds out about the... Oh, hey, please do. I look forward to it. Nathan, can you see the game okay?
Yes.
Okay. So let's see. I'm gonna see if we load the Claire A scenario thing and it lets us just start with Leon, because I don't know if it'll do that. I'm gonna experiment. Data's Claire's data. Okay.
Hmm. We've already played Claire's.
Yep.
We played what? Claire A and Leon B.
So now we're doing... I loaded Leon up, but... Because that's that weird thing. When it pops up, it says Claire or Leon. You got to pick them. And then it loads in the game and stuff. So... I don't remember hard at first. So maybe we unlocked hard by beating it earlier. But we're going to keep it at normal.
Resident Evil 2 Electric Boogaloo up in this bitch.
Now, I hope it shows the cutscenes. Please. Okay, we see the zombie.
A bizarre incident occurred in the outskirts of an American suburb called Raccoon City.
Wait, what?
It was later revealed that the terrible disaster
caused
by the T-virus.
The T-virus.
A mutagenic toxin created by the International Enterprise Umbrella Incorporated.
Okay, so it still countered it. Good.
Bioweapon experiments. The Raccoon City Police Department's Special STARS unit immediately began investigation in the affair. The case was apparently closed, thanks to the efforts of STARS members Chris Redfield and Jill Valentine.
And Barry Burton and Rebecca Chambers, don't forget them! And Brad!
But the Umbrella Corporation's experiments were far from...
Yeah, it's weird that it shows some cutscenes and not others, Nacho. You're right. I don't understand that. You want to unlock other modes and weapons. It depends on your grade. That's so it's not showing Leon driving the vehicle now. Why does it do that? No. That's so annoying. All right, well.
Vivid explanation.
I'm just gonna skip it.
Oh, we missed it.
Well, no, I'm gonna skip it because just stream can't see it. We both know what happens.
Let me just add in. That guy's a maniac. Why'd he bite me?
That guy's a maniac. Why'd he bite me? Where's my cheeseburger? My only clue is that the game doesn't show the pop-ups the game throws at you either. Yeah, I'm stupid. The thing that determines your grade is time to finish saves and how many first aid sprays. Yeah, because with Claire, I got like a C, but Leon, I used a first aid spray or two, so it gave me a fucking D. And I'm like, man, whatever. Sure. Okay, you do you. But we ain't playing this for perfect runs. I ain't no speedrunner. I ain't no, RE perfectionist. This is just us having fun, enjoying these games like we used to when we were younger. So I think some cutscenes are played on an overlay and OBS doesn't see that. Every first aid spray lowers your grade. Well, again, it is what it is. Okay. Excuse me. Herbs. Yeah, that's why I got hoard all the herbs, even though Bandit was bitching about me about it. I don't get the herbs. Alright, I need you to kindly fuck off.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Did we get boxed in?
Yeah, I know.
Oh, you juke him. Okay.
Yeah, I was trying to juke him. Sorry, excuse me. Nope, got... Now see, with Claire, he wasn't there, but here, it's... that's annoying. Bandit bitches, because I know. I poke fun at Bandit. I love him, too. He's a goofball. Boy. I sure hope nothing bad happened since I got into this gun shop.
Freeze!
Uh-oh.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
Hold your fire! Daughter? I'm a human!
I'm a human!
Cox gun again.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry about that. I thought you were one of them.
I thought you were one of them.
What's going on in this town?
Hold on.
I ain't got no clue, darling.
I don't have a clue. By the time I noticed something was wrong, the entire city was infested with zombies.
Fucking Nacho, yes, I do love Bandit enough to make him preganin out there.
Rig-neat.
Wait, hold on. I gotta remember he says something.
You should be safe inside here. I'm keeping a close eye on things.
Let's see.
Now here. Put this mini skirt on.
Put this on your penis. Now, like, we poked fun at him the other day, but, like, I always like to point out, thanks to, like, the Wildstorm comics and, like, novelization stuff, Kendo stayed behind, and even in RE2 Remake and RE3 Remake, he stayed behind, gave weapons and ammo to survivors to give them a fighting chance. He could have just said, fuck it, and left, but he stayed behind. That's why his store is as ransacked as it is. Granted, it could be probably just, you know, some people probably also stealing or something at one point, but he made sure people could at least protect themselves. He literally just could have said, fuck it, got in his Jeep and left. So, I hate what happens to him. Like, at least in the RE2 and RE3 Remake, we get more scenes with him, and it's nice that his relationship with the STARS members is touched upon, because him and his brother made the guns, the Berettas, the samurai edges for them. Yeah, RE2 Remake did give him a really sad situation with his daughter and what happened, but it's I don't know, like, in a way, it's kind of better because he wasn't alone and he just didn't needlessly die. He did what he could for his daughter and all this shit. Here, he's just a dude that, sadly, he's too close to his fucking mirrors right here, these windows that, like, in ensuing chaos, it's too bad he couldn't have, like, pushed something in front of them to make it to where they wouldn't just... You know,
they actually expanded on his character in the remake.
Yeah. Did you not get to play the remakes?
I did not. I saw people play through some of them.
Well, we should try to find a way to play through them so you can experience it. Like, let you, like, you should play it. I should just join you on stream and just, you know, the remake of 2 is very good. The remake of 3 is very much a letdown, as you've heard me and Bandit talk about it, and I will talk about it some more, at different points in time. But the remake of 2 is great because they actually put heart into it. They cared. It's just kind of disappointing that threes wasn't as good. All right, so we're gonna get ammo because we don't have to run into Brad unless. Do you want to try to run into Brad this run, or what do you think?
That's up to you. It's something new.
The only thing is, I worry about the ammo situation. So you remake.
Gotta make it to the police station without dying.
Do it. Okay, I can try. Remake three walked so Resistance could run. Resistance tripped over its own fucking feet and failed. See, odd that a gun store has normal glass windows. Most gun stores have either plate glass that's tough as shit or straight up have metal. Yeah, I don't know. I guess it was like, that's the 90s. All right, we're going to try this. We're gonna try to run into Brad. And I know when you run into him, I think you can go ahead and get some ammo after you like have him appear. So we'll just see. Wish me luck. This is the 90s in America. This is America. Just let me go. Fuck off.
Uh-oh.
Yeah. Maybe I should have tried for this in easy, where I wouldn't be nearly dead to run into his ass.
I wonder if you can go back for the shotgun after killing Brad.
I don't know. Hey, Animus Grimm, thank y'all for lurking. Dumpster invincibility, yep. What?
It's just that they just can't touch you.
Hey there, Itchy. Good to see you.
Itchy, hello.
I love their little falling tackle. Like, they're trying so desperate to get my fucking legs.
I think she's down for the count.
Yep, she's bleeding, making me the victor. Okay, he's... The one on the far right's not dead yet. The other two are. Mm-hmm. Given time for the fourth one to make it down the alley, yeah.
Yellow shirt means more HP, apparently.
Yep.
He still ain't dead.
Nope, like George said, the fourth one's coming now. It's like, God damn it.
He just wanted to see what all the commotion was.
What are y'all doing over here? Oh, hey, it's a feller. Let me eat on you, feller. I want to eat you. Why are you stabbing me? That's not very nice.
Goo. He's just carving them up like Thanksgiving turkey.
Uh-huh.
He still ain't dead.
No! It's not like the knife in Code Veronica. This knife doesn't do any fucking damage.
Oh my gosh. Did he die or did he just lunge?
No, he lunged. He lunged.
There he goes.
Okay. I just love it. Just run past him at this point. Well, I murdered his ass now, so.
Some survivor's gonna come through here and go, what happened here?
Yeah, what the fuck? Excuse me, gentlemen, I'm out of here. You too.
You got the two in here to deal with. Her death scream. Oh yeah, there you go.
Yep.
I think this is the other hard part, though.
Yep! Track!
Ooh. Holy cow, look at you dodge. Dodge and weave.
I have no health. Like, Brad's gonna kill me. Oh, there he is. I hear him.
Brad. No! Dang, he is tanking some bullets.
Mm-hmm. I damaged him, so I'm gonna see if I can come back with items and fuck him up.
I mean, you could probably just knife him at this point.
I have no health. I am in caution.
George said go into the police station. It's station.
Police station, hoo-ha-ha. What's going on in this station? Now, he's still going to be down there, so maybe I can find some ammo and go fuck him up real quick. Yep, there we go.
30 bullets. Ooh. Ooh, doggy.
I think, should I even bother save? Well, fuck it. We'll save it as one thing.
Not until you heal up.
Look, we can create the new, you know, if push comes to shove, you know, but I think with these bullets, it should be enough to take B-Rad down. Alright, Brad, it's time to send you on to hell. I feel bad that Brad kind of gets shit from folks, because, like, my friend, that was like a chopper pilot and in the army and stuff, Crystal, she kind of told me that Brad basically did proper procedure in leaving, because it's like if the chopper was compromised, you know, they would really be fucked, because, you know, when you get there, when they got there in RE1, the Bravo team's chopper is fucked. So if Brad hadn't left, he wouldn't be able to come back and get them later. Like, so, you know, I've come to understand, too, that, yeah, Brad was doing protocol, and also because after finding out Wesker's, you know, the fucking traitor, let's see if we can kill him. Special key! God, he put me in danger, you bitch. Yep, he's dead now, but I'm almost dead too.
Wasn't there herbs in that flower bed?
I know, at one point I think there might be. Let me check. Ooh. There we go. I almost want to go back for all the old ammo and the shotgun, but I don't know if it'd be worth it. Like, I wonder if I can just get a shotgun again later, or if that's the only chance I get the shotgun.
I don't know. I think it may be the only chance you get the shotgun.
Well, fuck. You can't leave. Well, god damn it. Okay, we'll get a shotgun later. Okay.
What do you mean you can't leave?
George said we can't go back. Oh, yeah, because the weapon locker, there's a chance for it to be the Magnum or the shotgun, I think. Maybe it'll be this, or a shoddy or something. Let's see, smoke weed every day, it'll be worth it. You know what, we got edibles. I need to do a stream after taking an edible and seeing how things go. You know what, just because I don't feel like killing B-Rat again.
Excuse me.
Bless you. Magnum B scenario, shotgun A scenario. Okay, so I'll get a shotty anyway. Marvin! Marvin! I'm coming. Ah, shit. What a moan in my ear.
Oh, man.
Who are you? Oh, you must be the new guy. Leon.
Yep, my name's Leon. How you doing?
Sorry, but it looks like your party has been canceled.
Marvin, why you dead?
About 2 months ago, there was this incident involving zombies.
Zombies.
In a mansion located in the outskirts of this city. Chris and the other STARS members discovered that Umbrella was behind everything. They risked their lives to reveal the truth, but no one believed them. Not long after that, all this started to happen.
Hang in there.
Don't worry about me. Just rescue the survivors in the other rooms. Here, take this key card. You should be able to unlock the doors in the hall with this. Now go.
But...
just go.
Fine, but I'm coming back for you. Just hold on.
Not until you're dead.
So 2 months ago, 0 and 1 happened, and 3 is currently happening. Yep. 3 happens 24 hours before and 24 hours after 2. That's why at some point when you're playing as Jill, you go in the RPD and you find Marvin, like, knocked the fuck out.
That's wild, the time frame for Raccoon City and the events of 0 were so close together.
Yeah. What survivors, Marvin, you silly goat, you're the only one left. I do love the idea that Leon, Claire, and Jill and Carlos could have run into each other at any point, and I kind of wish they would have. It would have been nice. Okay, go here. All this happened within a 2 month time span. Yeah, it's fucking wild, dude. Yeah, 2236. Okay, at least the code's the same. But I wouldn't give for all them herbs I had. No smoking in the RPD. Aww. I love that. I always thought it was so interesting that 3 different games happen all at once. Yep. Okay, before we go in there, hold on. I want to go to the other place over here to get some... I think there were some herbs you can access. Yeah, I really don't like the fact that the liquor is... something I gotta run into so early now, and I don't have the shoddy to blow his fucking brains out.
Oh, yeah.
Of course, I could try to get by him, go to the STARS office. Oh, fuck. Well, never mind.
There's a lot in here.
Yep.
Yeah, you could try to dodge roll and run past the liquor.
I wish you could dodge roll like Jill and RE3. I did love in the remake of RE4, they added, like, little dodge things for Leon and parries and shit. It was nice. Only had a small key, I could open that. Like, I really wish he had some handgun bullets on him. And I hate that the cutscene to liquor doesn't show on stream. Like, come on.
Oh boy.
Okay, it does, like you said, okay.
It does.
Weird.
I love how the music is not playing either, for some reason.
Running!
Oh. Sprint!
Yeah, that first aid, that herb would be nice, but no, that fucker can kill me one shot at caution, I think. You can, I'm glad you can juke him. I was able to juke him fairly well. I almost grabbed the herb. I was like, no. He'll fucking kill you. We read all these before. If there's any items somewhere, sometimes you can find little blessings.
Sody pop.
Okay, remember in RE3, if you you don't get Brad's card from his body after fighting Nemesis or shooting the run, Jill's card is in this room, I think. The ammo in the room of the painting? Nice. Hey, Revy, how you doing? Go ahead and do this. Back corner, thank you. Yay! Bullets.
Somebody got to the bullets.
Somebody got to the blood. What is that thing? It's like a weird troll like mascot thingy. It's weird!
This is one of the weirdest setups for a police station, too. Like, the layout is completely, like, this is not how a normal police station
works. Well, yeah. Like, we found out in both this and the remake, this is originally a fucking museum and shit, so. It's the 90s, so it's probably a troll reference. That makes sense.
Oh, God, I forgot about all these dudes.
That's a new one. Merge burrs. They took my gerb. I know one of y'all ain't dead. Unless maybe you're all dead. Oh, hello. I knew one of you was still alive. There's another one somewhere. Probably right by the save door. Oh, okay. Yay, herbs!
Snort them, mash them, put them in a stew.
Alright, we're doing great.
Herbs? Punch him. Oh boy.
Should we change our outfit?
Yeah.
Do we want the one on the left or the one on the right? Okay, George votes skull jacket.
I don't even remember what these two look like.
Well, you want me to show both of them?
Can you change into different ones?
I think
or
you can.
Only let you pick one.
I think you can. Well, George, you might know. Can't you go through them all and or is it a one-and-done thing? Because that would be stupid if it was a one-and-done thing. Okay. Well, here's the skull jacket. But please wait a minute.
Bad all right. Boy Leon.
Now there's that. And it's gonna put me back in the RPD. Oh, no, wait, here's the other one.
Oh.
We get an RP. Like you like this one?
Look at these guns.
Oh! Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that.
It's a gangster. It's a kill shot.
Uh-huh. All right, so you vote for this one. George votes for the skull jacket. We can leave it to chat or can do a poll. I don't know how to do polls, sadly, but we can just see what people think that's in chat. If you say, do you want this or do you want the skull jacket?
Nacho, is you still in chat? Make us a poll.
If you don't mind, if you can. If not, don't worry about it. That, you know. That is an interesting purple on him too.
I don't think I've ever seen this outfit.
We're gonna save real quick. RPD training uniform. Yeah, that makes sense with the cap. Ratatata.
I think it's funny that his posture changes from holding the gun to.
Uh-huh. Exposed arms. Mm-hmm. Now, I wonder if it does that for both the outfits. Let me check. It's cool we unlocked it, though. We can do RPT training uniform? Okay. See, now we can choose to yes, no, and original. Here, I need to check. I want to check to see if the gunshot holster is the same. Okay. But either way, he's popping fools. There. I can't remember what Claire gets for the outfits too, but I'm sure they're really cool.
One of hers, I think, is like a biker outfit. I mean, that's mm-hmm. I know it's her normal one, but she gets like a different jacket. I wish they had changed one of her outfits to be the 1.5
yeah.
outfit.
Yeah, Elsa Walker. It'd be nice. I know in some games she has that as an alternate costume. Let's see. Denim jacket and Colt. Also a red headband. Okay. Is there anything on the desk? Hold on.
That's about it.
Yeah, I think we read all these. Yeah, we're Elliot. Like, in the remake, Elliot's actually a cooler character, because in this game, apparently he's that guy with the mustache that with the helicopter that shoots it down. Apparently that's him. But in the remake, he's Elliot.
Elliot.
Okay, yeah, she gets the remakes. RE2 remake, she gets the Elsa suit. They get, like, RE2 remake, they gave them a butt-fuck ton of extra costumes. RE3 cool. remake, we get Jill's classic outfit. In a way, and then Carlos gets his classic hair. And I'm like, why couldn't you give Carlos and the UBCS like their OG outfits? Like, and you know, no other extra costumes other than that. I'm like, that's just so fucking lazy. And but it's like, oh, they put all their work in Resistance. Well, fuck Resistance. I hated that game. Every time I tried to play it, like, I never could find anybody that friends with me to play it with. And then I try to play it and it just goes.
Heard of Resistance.
It's basically
your vitriol for it.
It's basically Dead by Daylight, but shittier. And I'm being nice by calling it that. Yeah, you automatically get Resistance if you buy Resident Evil 3 Remake. That's just how, you know, they put all their effort into Resistance, though, because they were hoping it would be, you know, like, not a Dead by Daylight killer, but, oh, it would breathe life into RE Online Gaming, and I'm sitting here going, re-release Outbreak 1 and 2, and you'll get that, you stupid motherfuckers. I mean, what? I mean, I'm sorry to say that out loud. Apparently I didn't say it fucking loud enough. Tell us how you really feel. I mean, I can. I can rant about it all day. Oh, you want, okay, you want me to go for it? All right, hold on. I'm going to go put this gem down here. Like, I'm pissed because the remake of 3, they cut a bunch of content. They cut out the clock tower. Nemesis doesn't get his second form where he's slightly damaged and more tentacly. He goes from trash bag man to on all fours fish dog thing because he falls in the water and Jill says the funny line, bitch can't even swim. We got the new drip by killing Brad. Now we're like this. Bah! I'm gonna put the controller down a second. I'm disappointed because 3 deserved as much love as 2. 2 got like extra game modes. There's the Ghost Survivors, you have an alternate campaign thing you can do for Kendo, for a umbrella hunk soldier guy. You can the tofu game has multiple tofus you can play. There's a bunch of extra costumes that you can get the OG soundtrack and noises if you want for stuff. Like, they put in a lot of shit for RE2 Remake. RE3 Remake, they put all their efforts into Resistance because Capcom outsourced RE3 Remake to another team. So they just did shit and focused on Resistance. And it's not that Remake for 3 is all bad. I've enjoyed it every time I played it, but it's so lackluster. Once you finish it, there's no point in... There's no extra modes. They didn't bring back the Mercenary mode from 3. The extra game stuff is stupid. Like, oh, you get a knife that's a flame knife, and it's called the Hot Dogger. It's so stupid. The extra stuff for Carlos is fun. Playing as him in the game is fun. He gets more scenes and more stuff to do. Mercenary mode for OG RE3 was fucking badass. Like, I loved Mad Jackal mode. Oh, I'm being raided. Let me let the raid thing go through where I can hear. Hey there, Jay. How you doing? Welcome in to you and your raiders. It's good to see y'all. For those of you that don't know who I am, my name is Soulstone. You can call me Soul. I'm a sometimes robot PNG tuber. Oh, hey there, Ziggy. Good to see you. Yeah, it had the best merc mode. Like, RE3 OG had the best merc mode. I loved it so much. I played it so much. Thank you for shouting Jay out. But anyway, I'm playing OG RE2. Normally, it would be me and Bandit, and now we've added my dear friend here next to me, Finn, who's a kick-ass kaiju, along for the ride. Thank you for raiding. If you want to lurk, !lurk. If you want to stay in chat, there's plenty of cool people to chat with, including yourselves now. Or if you got a raid and run, I understand. But hello there, Jay. Hello there, Sky. Ziggy, good to see all y'all. Hope you're doing well. Got the infinite ammo through that mode. Yeah, the OG RE3 merc mode gave you infinite ammo for weapons if you beat it. Like, yeah, Bandit is resting. He had like an 8-hour thing he did earlier today, so he's exhausted. I understand that. Remake was a fun time, but it's very lackluster in content. There's no point in continuing to play it. The nightmare mode I hear is janky. Nemesis's AI is fucking busted to where he is ridiculously cheap. And another thing that's disappointing is what they did for Nemesis in OG RE3, where, you know, he had some scripted parts he would show up, but he also would just randomly appear. They did that for Mr. X in the remake of RE2, and every appearance of Nemesis in 3 Make is scripted, and you can just hear it coming a mile away. You're not scared, you're not surprised. So it's disappointing, because they took from Nemesis, and he's my favorite BOW in Resident Evil. There were some good things for 3 Make. Like, I loved that they gave all the UBCS mercenaries more personalities. We got to have Tyrell and Carlos be friends instead of Tyrell and the OGs just, hey, I'm here, I'm dead. 3 Make of Metamorphosis was rad as hell, though. Yeah, I mean, there's some good stuff for 3 Make there, but it's just so... It could have been so much more. Like, if they'd put the same love into it they did in RE2 Remake, I'd be very happy. I would be streaming that game so damn much just because. But, like, for all the good it did, there's just so much that's just lackluster. You're literally locked out from going to certain places just so you can... Yeah, Nemesis. Yep. Mm-hmm. That's it. It's... Again, it feels more streamlined versus the original where you had choice. You had tons of choices you could do. That's the beauty of that of the OG RE3. You could play it five times and each time to be different because of the choices you made. I'm going to head out, but I hope... Yeah, okay, Jay. Have a good one. Thank you for raiding anybody that sticks around from your community. I promise we'll take good care of them. And with Resistance, like I've said before, every time I've tried to play it, I'll randomly reinstall it and try to play it. Because I can't find anybody that wants to play it, you know, so I just do it myself. I'll reinstall it, I'll go online, I'll join a lobby of randoms and a random mastermind who's level 600, and he'll kill us all in 5 minutes, and my teammates won't help me, they will leave me to die, and I'm just a little level 10 here, not knowing what I'm doing. And I'm like, you know, yeah, I don't see why this game's here. Fuck it. Let's see, 3 mates should have been an open world Raccoon City. Yep, you're right. And 3-mate McKyle was 11 out of 10. They really did improve him. He was already awesome in OG. They made him even more awesome. Like, I love the fact that they got the guy that played Gorman from Aliens to be both Mikhail and that that scientist guy. That's like, I'm so-and-so. I made the antidote here. Save me, damn it. You know, like...
Wait, what?
Yeah. Gorman's actor is in 3 as Mikhail and this scientist that Carlos and Tyrell have to save at some point. What's his fucking name?
I'm fairly certain you told me and I forgot.
But yeah.
What?
I might have said that. Again, if you get the remakes and want to run through them with me on call, I would love that because I think you need to experience them. Like, you know. Or if we just say, fuck it, I'll just get the games again, go through them again because I don't know. I'm fine with replaying it with homies. But yeah, I found that out and I was blown away that Gorman's actor plays Mikhail, not only voices him, but does the mocap for him. And then he plays the Nathaniel Bard, that's his name. He's the scientist, like, I'm Nathaniel Bard, damn it, save me. Yeah. It's so cool they got, you know, an Aliens actor to be in fucking Resident Evil, but, you know. Anyway, my rant is over, we'll get back to the game. I expected Resistance to be better. I expected Resident Evil 3 Remake to be a hell of a lot better. It's just, again, it's my favorite, so I was let down in a lot of ways. Some ways, it made me happy. What are you, some kind of butt pooper? I mean, that's usually how it goes, boy. Hello there, how you doing?
I'm gonna need all the fiber to move all these buildings out.
Uh-huh. We all expected 3 Make to be better, honestly. Especially after 2 was so good. Dr. Important Man Von McGuffin. Yeah, honestly, Bard was that. Also, another thing that made me sad is as much as I love, what's his name? He played, Astarion, and also he was, Heisenberg in Village, Neil Newbon. I loved him as Nikolai, but I hated that you immediately knew Nikolai was going to betray you and everything because he's just such a fucking asshole and immediately evil. I'm like, in the original, it's subtle. He's still working together with Mikhail and Carlos to get out of there. But in the remake, he's like, nah, fuck these guys. I'm out for number one. Immediately. It's like, okay, well, we're going to just speed run how much you need to die, I guess. Alright, I got the jewels.
I hate that they put all this love and care into the remake for 2, which I'm happy about. But, you know, they just kind of shit on the one that it's your favorite.
No, I'm happy at least that 2 make is good, but... It's because 2 is very popular, and they had to not fuck it up, because the fandom would eat them alive. See, to be fair, they speed run straight to the train, and yep, they do. Like, it's so quick. Like I do love there are references to stuff, like in 3 Make, you find the railroad that Jim from Outbreak works for. You find that rail station, that's part of the train stuff, and there's a pet shop named after Eagle from Street Fighter, you know, the really cool blonde guy with the Eskrima sticks that sadly is only in, like, other Street Fighter games when he's not in the mainline one. He was in, like, the first Street Fighter, and then he just shows up in a bunch of the extra ones, which is sad. Because, you know, in this game, at the start, there's Oruka's, which is Sakura from Street Fighter. But it's just, you know, I'm not super upset. I'm just disappointed because I wanted better for my game. But I'm happy that 2 was good because, you know, oh, wow, it shoots a lot faster.
It's because of kill shots. Dang, he's popping caps in.
Bow down to a true pimp. Okay. You basically run right past Dario. Yep. What makes me sad is you don't get to go back and find Dario like in the original. Like, you never see his ass again. And whoever they got to play Dario was funny. Like, I liked him. He basically played Dario as an overweight Trevor from GTA. But... yay, shoddy!
Hell yeah.
Hey, hey, hey. They're playing our song.
Rifle through Rebecca's desk.
I mean, she ain't gonna... She don't need anything here. Fuck. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We read this already. Dash boomin' stickin'. Oh, hey.
Leon!
It's good to see you're still among the living.
Leon, I didn't realize...
It looks like we're not gonna find your brother here after all.
I found his diary. That means he's not here.
Welcome to the gun show, Claire.
There's no reason for us to stay any longer than necessary. Let's split up, look for any survivors, and get out of here.
Right.
One last thing. Here's a radio. Take it. That way we can keep in touch if anything happens.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Leon. I'm too distracted by your polygonal pecs.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that Barry's desk?
Yep. He's got the fish right here and the gun. Let's see. Hey, Leon. Damn, you ain't dead, bitch. You look pretty casual for your first day. He's rude. Also in Remake 2, Leon and Claire are super flirty with each other. Yeah, yeah. It's the Stars team, and most of them are dead by this game. I could have swore there was some ammo somewhere. Oh, hey, Claire's looking at her brother's desk.
I can't believe what is happening to this city.
There's ammo behind Wesker's desk. Oh, okay. Shit, I thought I... Just double checking. Capcom likes hiding shit behind desks. They really do.
That sounds like a metaphor.
I almost wish I could take the skull jacket, because I think with this outfit, the skull jacket would look cool. Get that shoddy ready. Oh, yeah, you know I am. I'm gonna, here we go. We got a shoddy with a body. Too bad I can't hold the shotgun all up in the air one-handed and break my arm.
No, you could totally pull off, oh my god, what's her name?
Alice?
Linda Hamilton?
Oh, Linda, yeah.
T2 style, just one arm, one hand shotgun blast.
It was like, blam! This pre-Devil May Cry? Yeah, pretty much. Okay. Now, I guess I can keep the medallion. Because the Unicorn Medallion goes in the statue, right? In the lobby? Okay. Here. I'm going to put the first aid spray up. We're going to try to get a good grade this run through. Let's see. Trying to think. That would bring the jewels or wait. Probably wait.
Yeah, it'll be a little bit before you put those in there.
So we still gotta get through that fucking liquor and stupid.
And Elliot's gotta get shot up or gotta get chowed on by the zombos.
Mm-hmm.
Elliot?
Elliot? Ah! Ah! Let me go! Stop twisting my nipple! Stop it! Stop it!
That one was grabbing your junk. Dang.
Yeah, grabbed my junk and twisted my nipple. Jesus Christ.
Some horny zombies.
Yeah, I guess so. Shit, I just realized the cat's locked in here with me. Hold on. Yeah, I'll get you in a minute.
Hey, cat, do you want out of the red room? Out. I know you're hunting, but here, I'm busy.
Those guns are irresistible. Mm-hmm. It's like that line from Rap Battles of History with Leonidas versus Master Chief. It's like, I don't need firepower when I'm rocking these guns. Alright.
Just gonna get this little thing, don't worry about me. Is he on the city? Yep, there he is. Shoot him in the butt. He glitched.
Did it count for me to hit him? I think so, because there was blood, right?
Yeah, there was blood. But he sure didn't come after you.
Hey! Asshole!
This liquor is,
touched.
He's been licking something.
How many licks does it take to get the center of an RPD rookie? We're not going to find out. He's blind, he's trying. Come on, stupid.
Three shots? Dang.
About one or two licks. I came in at the perfect time. Hey there, Octo. Yeah, I think the first one didn't do enough damage to him. Fine. Reeve, you didn't buy him dinner.
Don't work.
Do what?
I said note to self, ass shots don't work.
Yeah. You're immune to back shots, I see. How dare. Woo! Also, I always mean to say at the start of the stream, but if anybody finds a moment that is funny for you, please clip it so I can look back and enjoy it. Because clips are like little memories, and I enjoy them. Why do you think they keep presenting their asses to you? I mean, fair, I guess. They think Leon's an ass man, but, you know, push comes to shove. It's like these things are going to try to kill me while doing that, so no. Which reminds me, in the Resident Evil manhwas, I think they were Korean-made, like, mangas and shit. There was one story I remember. Leon had a liquor that I just would not leave him alone. Like, it just kept coming back, and he's like, "What the fuck is your problem? How many times I gotta kill you?" Ada doesn't. Let's see. Well, Ada doesn't the best breast in the world. It's just double checking.
Didn't they try to tie the lore? Or correct me if I'm wrong. Wasn't the link between zombies and liquors like
crimson heads? Like, yeah, the crimson heads. They did that.
Supposed to turn into liquors.
They did that in remake. Yeah, basically, if a zombie is downed but not burned, it will turn into a crimson head, and the crimson heads survive long enough, they'll turn into liquors.
Hmm. Weird.
Yep. Interesting concept, though.
Yeah, I always thought the liquors were just BOWs that they made.
Yeah, they ferment the zombies in vats to turn them into liquors. fermented in the bottle is Vince's date.
Umbrella
France. The French.
I've always been inspired by that military applications. Toxic indeed.
Like kimchi, but deadly.
You did have a clip of this part right here where you managed to headshot three of them at once.
Yeah, that was so cool. I'm glad that somebody clipped it. It was worth it to clear the hall. Another green herb. Don't mind if I do. Hey, Cece, how you doing? It's good to see you. Oh. Do we need to come down here yet? I don't know. I'm jumping ahead accidentally. Get some of the all-natural medical smokes. Smoke. I'm glad you're doing better, CC. I can't remember the spay key works down here. I'm jumping ahead. All right. Nothing else. I at least cleared those zombies out, so don't have to worry about them. Had dinner at my auntie's place, Southern Cooking, and I ate, three plates full. Man, there's one thing about the Southern, Southern situation. The home cooking is goddamn good. We know how to eat back home for goddamn sure. I miss the home cooking sometimes. Ooh, wait. There was a little corner I wanted, like, right there as you come in. Like, there could be some ammo there. I don't know if there is, but I feel like checking it. Nope, okay. Oh yeah, the loading doors. That's one of the things I love about the original three games, the doors with the loading. Okay, I don't have much places to go, so let me go back through here. Now that we got the spade key. I'll put one away. I gotta say, the old PS1 98 models look good on PC. Like, it looks really nice.
It's a blast from the past, for sure.
Mm-hmm. I love how I do have an RPD hat similar to the one Leon has on, but it's got the RPD in smaller letters, and it's got the police shield in the middle. It's the one I took that selfie with, I share off, and it's like VTuber versus their real self. One thing that always amazes me about the doors is that they only have a surprise behind them once, and they waited until the second game to do it. Yep. CD Projekt Red did a good job updating these games. Wait, CD Projekt Red did this? That's crazy. Good for them.
Wow.
Oh, they own GOG. I got you. I did not know. Modern games would have a zombie behind every third door. Yeah. Don't try to grab my butt. Oh shit, I thought that key opened. Okay, hold on. I mean, if I remember in 3, well, those stairs have a bloodstain on them. This door still is won't open. It looks like there's blood on the bottom of the door, so I'm just like, I just wonder what the fuck happened there.
Playing OG 2 and 3, and they were never able to open that door once. It was like, weird.
Yeah, what the fuck? What? What the fuck? That window at the bottom of the stairs. Yep, gives me, yeah. Because I'm waiting for Nemesis to pop out, like in 3. Yeah, mm-hmm. Ziggy. You know what I'm talking about. Oh, shit.
Feeding frenzy. Oh, you got a 2-for-1.
Let's try this again. Well, I got 2. Was that him moving that I heard that let? Okay.
He twitched.
We got a twitcher. Yay, boulets. And most of them went in the gun. That's the other side of that door. Oh, okay. I need some small key. Oh boy, this puzzle. Oh man, it's
easy.
Bunch of steel chairs. I wish you could just like pick them up and just yeet them at zombies or hit them with it. Yeah, red herb. Let's go.
It's Leon with the steel chair.
My God, they're broken in half. Bum 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 bum. Hold on, I'm gonna see what's up here real quick. Save room. I was convinced the door handle was on the wrong side. Had to look. Oh no, wait, this is the upper. By God, with a steel chair. This is the clock tower thing, I think, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'm remembering.
Yosh.
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 He ran by the crank room. God damn it. It's in the liquor hall. Oh, okay. Wait, because my key should unlock it now, right? I forgot to try that goddamn door. Fuck! Well, this is Resident Evil.
Up here, so
yeah.
Well
yeah, I'll do this. I'll do this and then... Bah!
Oh.
Bah. Okay, I need to
well,
try
that's
to...
it, Leon. I'm kicking your ass.
Now imagine if Mr. X sounded like that shit.
Come here, I'm just gonna punch you.
Oh wait, I meant right. Fuck. Yeah, baby! Limbs, Pat Astley, yep. I don't need my legs. I can't feel my legs.
I knew it was coming.
I can't help it. It's a great reference. Like, I saw where My Way Entertainment uploaded all 4 of the Juggernaut bitches in a post. And I think I bookmarked it, but I retweeted it, and they liked my retweet. Where I was like, you know, please watch these. They're internet history, for fuck's sake. Dang it, Sherry, give me the damn sample. Okay, wait. What's through here? No. If I had ammo, it'd be different, but no, not now.
Quick, turn around. No.
Yeah. Well, it ain't like in 3 where you had quick turns. You had to do it old school in 1 and 2. You had to just slowly turn and pray to God they don't bite your ass. Because they will, too. I want a soda or a coffee or whatever there is. Well, yeah, soda, you bastard. And also, the alternate costume reminds me, in Resident Evil 6, we almost had a costume where Leon had the merchant on his back in the mercenary mode, and he could, like, shoot alongside you and shit. I'm like, we should have had that. Fuck you for not giving us that, Capcom. Chocolate! Give me that chocolate! A good old juicy wreck. Alright. Quick stop in the save room to get rid of the bishop key, because I don't need that shit right now. I don't need that shit! We're already an hour 25 in, and we spent like a little bit of time just like the first 15 minutes bullshitting, so we're making good progress for just starting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was...
Yeah.
What were you gonna say? Sorry.
No, I was gonna say, I was waiting for Bandit to show, but I guess I can go ahead and ask you now, too. I was just gonna, spend some time talking about Resident Evil and stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, I was gonna ask you, what was your first, that you can remember, your first honest-to-God interaction with the franchise?
Okay, yeah, I'll answer that. Again, my first interaction with the game was 2. Funny enough, I don't remember how, but it was back when, it was RE2 on PC. Somehow I had gotten a hold of the game. I can't remember how, but it had the PC port that had a disc for Leon and a disc for Claire. And funny enough, it had the arranged mode where you could have the submachine gun and shit. So I, you know, for shits and giggles, went through the game with the submachine gun to experience it. And I remember vividly at one point as Sherry having the submachine gun just shooting motherfuckers. I was like, oh wow. But yeah, I played through 2, loved it. And I'm like, okay, this series is fucking phenomenal. Hell yeah. So I got into it from that, and then I discovered the joys of the internet and made a bunch of friends that were into Resident Evil, and I played the other games. I went back and played 1, then I played 3, and then Code Veronica came out, and that was when, like, that group of friends and I were forming our little Resident Evil roleplay sessions and stuff, and we called ourselves the Regs, and because we regulated the chat, because it was back when Yahoo had, like, Yahoo Chat RP and this thing called Cheetah Chat, like a little server and stuff, and we basically regulated, because you'd have motherfuckers that would come in with fucking anime characters in Raccoon City, and we're like, what the fuck's wrong with you? No, don't do this. Don't do this shit. You know, you're banned. You fucked. Because I have a vivid memory as well of, there was an Alice RP'er, it was the time when the fucking first movie came out, and this Alice RP'er was in there causing shit and ruining the flow. I said, alright, I got this. So I jump into a Nemesis sign-in name, and I hunt her down as Nemesis, and through the RP process, roleplay process, I basically beat the hell out of her and crucified her on the side of a building and let crows feast on her.
Jesus.
Because, again, she was in there ruining other people's RP. I didn't just do this because. She literally stepped in, was fucking with other people doing their own thing, and I'm like, alright, you have awoken the beast.
My name is Alice, and I'm here to save Raccoon City.
Uh-huh, and I was like, nope, you're here to be crow food. See, mine was when I was in 3rd grade. My dad got it and wanted to show me because he was worried it was too scary for me. Plot twist, it was. I tapped out at Kendo's. Oh, Ziggy. Damn, motherfucker. I mean, again, it was the early days of the internet, the chat thing. And we gave them chances. Like, literally gave them chances. Like, there was one time there was a random, like, horny furry RP'er that was there trying to mess everybody. I said, all right, you know what? William Birkin, I'm gonna beat the shit out of you with this pipe and fucking kill you. I just, you know, we would tolerate stuff if they were cool and didn't cause a ruckus, but it was always these knuckleheads. And I told you about that guy, Ron, right?
Yes, I do remember this.
For people that don't know, because I haven't talked about my RE roleplay stuff, there was a guy, like in our group, we had a guy like named Lewis, who was a really good role player, really good storyteller. And unfortunately, he caught the attention of this fuck nugget that is named Ron. And Ron's situation was, he was one of those guys, he had to play the most overpowered characters all the fucking time. And then he started bringing in stupid shit, like he made a Thank you for the posture check. He made like a fucking pred-alien monstrosity that was stalking Lewis, and Lewis managed to escape it legally through RP and stuff. Like, Ron couldn't fucking touch him. And Ron, always so pissed off, because he's like, I need to beat Lewis. He's the only one of y'all I give a shit about. But then he talked shit to me one day and said, you know what, Ron? I will happily 1v1 your ass right now. Name the stipulation. I gave him the stipulations. He says, all right, you'll be your Wesker, because I had become like the top Wesker RPer. Because this, again, was when Code Veronica was still the newest entry. And it was still when Wesker wasn't, you know, psychotic in 5 and shit. And I said, all right, you want my Wesker, okay? Here's, and he's like, you know, Wesker's basic things, yada, yada, nothing. And I'm like, you know what? I'm going to do this. I'm going to basic Wesker. He's going to have a Smith & Wesson revolver with only the 6 bullets in it and a combat knife, and that's all I have. You bring your biggest bullshit, motherfucker, and we will roll. So he makes up this character, because I guess he was big into Guyver. He makes this zoonoid creature that apparently William Birkin created or some bullshit that got out and was like wreaking havoc. And I'm just like Wesker standing on a rooftop waiting for this shit, tapping my foot like Sonic the fucking Hedgehog. He takes, in real life, at least 2 days to type out all his bullshit just so he can get to me. Because it's like, you know, I'm just sitting there like, man, I got stuff to do. I got to go eat. So I'll check back in on this, you know, the next day. He finally gets to my ass because, you know, we had paragraph RP. So you write out the story, and like somebody, you know, they, like say somebody attacks you, they do a paragraph of what they're doing, how they're doing it, and setting it up. So you have to respond in kind. So he finally shows his ass up, his big zoonoid B.O.W. big ass motherfucker. And he's like, I'm going to charge at you like a rhinoceros, and I'm going to beat your ass if I get you. You better do something. And I'm like, all right, fam, I got you. So I have it to where Wesker rushes forward as well and does the whole thing of, you know, you see in Code Veronica, Wesker can jump and all the shit super fast, super high. I have him jump over the zoonoid creature, whipping out the magnum as he do, and I fire 3 precise shots. One, it just in the front of his fucking face just to piss him off. One on the top of his head. And the third one in the back where the brainstem would be, because, you know, Wesker would have that kind of heightened vision shit, right? Well, motherfucker tries to go, this don't work because he's got, like, adamantium skin or some shit and blah, blah, blah. And he's like, you didn't stipulate that at the start of the thing, motherfucker. And what's great is he brought a friend to make sure I wouldn't cheat, I say with air quotes. And his friend goes, nah, dude, he killed your ass. So one turn, I smited this motherfucker, and he was so pissed off, and I'm like, see you later, homie. Get fucked. I did it legally. Even yo homie said, nah, man, he fucking killed your ass in one turn. And I'm like, be gone. And that's not even the funniest.
Ron.
Yeah, that's not even the funniest way he got killed, either. Like, the funniest way he got killed was he tried to mess with another one of our friends named Dan, and he ended up fucking with Dan and fucking up his thing, and basically the giant alligator ate him. This dude had the worst fucking luck, and it's just like his determination was almost admirable, but it's like, dude, just stop. And then my friend Chris I mentioned earlier, she ran into the motherfucker in real life at some point. They were both joining the army together, and he was trying to give her shit and all this stuff. He bombed the thing. He didn't even get the army. Like, he fucked up, and she's like, be gone, you know. And I'm like, wow, you met the legend. He was basically our DSP or low-tier god. He was essentially the fucking precursor to those. It's so wild. Literally the one character wouldn't work. Yeah, I know, right? Try hards, die hard. They do. Also, if your B.O.W. gets to be a Zoonoid, my character gets to be a Kamen Rider. Yeah, I should have had Wesker just fucking go, Henshin.
Henshin.
Rider, let's kick go. Your ass. Turns out it was low tier god the entire time. Now, would that be a twist? That would be a fucking twist. Anyway, that was a free story time for everybody. I apologize. Hopefully that made you chuckle, because I often looked at it and just go, man, I was always nice to him too. We were all tolerantly nice, because he still was just a shithead. But I was like, I'm not going to let him ruin my flow. But it's just sad that, again, he stepped to me and just died so easily. Thank you for the hydrate. Because after he, you know, after I lost, I mean, after he beat me, he was like, oh, man, well, you're just a fucking punk, blah, blah, blah. I'd beat your ass in real life, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, okay, yeah, defer back to, you know, the bullshit, because this isn't about real life. You stepped up to me in this situation, homie, you know. When stepped to the king, you better be prepared to die. What were you going to say, Finn? I'm sorry.
I remember any time we could just trigger you at the drop of a hat by going, Ron.
Yeah, he used to drive us wild, man. Like, it was amazing how determined he was to fuck with everybody. And it's just like, we kind of tolerate your ass for some reason, because Lewis is like, no, he can't do anything. Just let him be a big fucking man, baby. And it's like, okay. Okay,
also,
now.
It's really funny that you took out a furry role player with Birkin, because it's like, part of me just wanted to say, ooh, woo, inflate you with G-baby.
I mean, again, it's one of those things. I have nothing, even back then, I had nothing against furries. It's just this guy came in, was like, you know, gifts you while you're doing this. It's like, dude, we're fighting zombies over here, and you're trying to fuck somebody, and you're doing all that. No, be gone. Get out of here. Taking out furry RPers, now you're surrounded by furries. I mean, again, there's a fine line between somebody that knows when it's appropriate and when it's just somebody who's trying to be a fucking troll or being a shithead. And it's like, nah, we gotta nip this in the bud.
Furries, where? Looks at own model.
Again, I love furries. I have so many friends that are furries. It's just this guy came in, caused trouble, and it was like, you know, my fellow Regs looked at me and said, Ben, you know what you have to do? And I'm like, alright, who should I be? Mr. X, Birkin, Nemesis? Yeah, fuck it, we ball. It's Birkin. Resident Furry here. We hate the tryhards too. Let's see, yeah, I know what they're doing. Like, low-key cannot say what I want to say because to you. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, again, if you can be just kind and respectful and do your thing, because I'd have left them alone. They could have RP'd their situation, you know, because the thing with RP is, you know, anything can happen, but if you have to make it make sense. You can't just be like, manifests in here, you know, ooh, ooh, hey, zombie, how's your bolts? You know. Hey, Stitch, how you doing? Good to see you. And from what I remember, because, again, this was me when I was, like 12 or 13. It's been a long time. I still have faint memories of shit. You need some self-awareness. Yeah. Yeah, and again, we had rules at the top of the chat room. It's like, you know, don't be a dick. If you're going to roleplay with somebody, ask. You know, you be mindful of situations, and that's all you had to do. It is not a difficult thing to just, you know, RP and do a good job. I'm actually working on a zombie apocalypse sort of RPG. Right, let's go. I love that shit.
Nice.
Yeah, one of my favorite things Finn and I did in our younger D&D games was a Resident Evil one-shot. That he DM'd, and there was a time I DM'd it. We kept passing the torch around, having fun with it. But it was a good time. Like, again, it's just one of those things. You get friends together, you're going to have a good time. All right, I need to get to the... I think I go up, right? Because I got to get up to the library. Yeah, I think this is the right way to go.
Yes.
Okay.
I have vague memories of that. Because I know we did another one, like, way later. I think it was closer towards when 5 came out.
Mm-hmm.
We were like BSAA agents.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I remember that too. Also, Strange, hello! See, there's a great tabletop game called Powered by the Apocalypse. It has inspired many rules. Ooh, yeah, it does sound.
Yeah.
All this talk is making nostalgic for all flesh must be eaten. Once knew someone whose character had, but not limited to, Archmage-level magic, adamantium claws, vampirism, her own version of Excalibur, and mech from Escaflowne. It was tiring to deal with. We all just kind of humored her. Welcome back, Lux. And yeah, I get that. We had some of those folks come in, and there was times where we're like, you know what, we're going to lax the rules a little bit, because, again, RP, you know, is like AU stuff, multiverse stuff. You can make stuff happen. But don't be a dick. Don't be weird. And I say that, but like I said, the Alice RPer, she came in and she started fucking with everybody. You know, it's like, because, like, person is like, I'm fighting for my life against zombies. She swoops in and kills them all and then goes away. And the person's like, I'm trying to write here. You know, I didn't ask for your fucking help. You know,
some people just can't read the room or understand the basic limitations of the setting that you're playing in.
Mm-hmm.
The same can be applied to D&D.
Oh, yeah. One of my favorite ones I did as like a partial solo RP is I roleplayed a survivor in Raccoon City that got bitten and he was slowly turning. And I basically roleplayed up until the point where, like, I had him literally survive and right before Raccoon blew up and he started to turn. So it's like he, you know, he lasted as long as the city did, you know, and I had him, he got hurt, he got bitten, he fought things, he went through so much shit, but it wasn't just like, I'm main character, I'm immediately powerful. No, this dude was a normal Joe that literally fought to the bitter end and, you know, did what he could. Resident Evil AU character, Leon the Rock Kennedy. It is Leon Kennedy played by the Rock, lol. Well, it's funny you say that. A friend of mine, just to make fun of all the people making OP characters, made a character called Krill Redsker that was a weird fusion clone of Chris and Jill, but also had Wesker powers and all this shit. It was from the future, and it's just...
Krill Redsker.
Introducing my Sparkle Dog Redamon OC. Nuzzles pounces on you, woo. God forbid we have, stakes in danger. Finally, The Rock has come back to Raccoon City. Oh, yes. See, this is why I love all y'all. Y'all get me and you make great jokes, too. Like, I even had a stint of having an OC. I had an OC named Warren Prime, who was a youth that had been experimented on because Wesker was like, I'm going to do this and that and everything. And I gave him some slightly OP abilities, but I balanced it for the fact it's like, well, he tries to do this and it, like, say he heals himself, well, he's also going to deal with like a lot of trauma and shit. I read your name as Pupper Girl and was like, yep, that makes sense. Wesker loved experimenting with, yeah, apparently. He's like, I love the young people.
The Wesker children before the Wesker children.
I like 5, but I just thought the weird shit of, oh, this whole time Wesker was an experiment, and then it's like Birkin also double-crossed him. I'm like, come on, man. Like, I've said it very often. Like, it's not unheard of that Wesker and Birkin would have done stuff to each other, but they also had mad respect for each other and were the closest thing either one of them had to a friend, let alone best friend. And I don't think Birkin... Oh, go ahead.
I was just going to say, they both orchestrated together the demise of Marcus so
yep.
that they could rise further up the ladder.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, Spencer slipped them the idea, but they ran with it because, like, well, shit, we were going to do this anyway. Okay, so
Spencer trying to be Palpatine.
Yep, Spencer had me assassinated. Like, if they put Zero... if I get a hold of Zero, you'll have to join me in Bandit so we can get to that point and laugh.
The funny thing to me about this series, this franchise, is that after 1, 2, 3, Code Veronica, and even, well, 4 didn't... 4 was kind of a divergence because it wasn't really a part of, you know... It wasn't focused on BOWs and Umbrella and the
mm-hmm.
downfall of Umbrella. But after all these games and Marcus... Or not Marcus, Spencer being name-dropped so many times, you're thinking, like, okay, eventually we're going to have a game where we have to deal with Spencer. And then, lo and behold, he shows up in 5 for the first time. And then Wesker kills him. And he's like, wow, that was anticlimactic.
Yeah, like Spencer should have been a threat of some type. It just was so annoying to see him, because this motherfucker deserved to have a boss fight and get fucking obliterated instead of getting a hole punched through him like he was a piece of paper. He was supposed to be the main bad guy in 4, but they changed that. But 4 panned out okay. I liked what happened with 4, the OG one. Like, the remake, there's some things I like, but there's some things in the remake that kind of are lackluster. Like, I don't like how Sadler looks like such a monster man to begin with already. Like, there's no charming cult leader in the beginning. He's just straight up like, I'm Palpatine. Like, no. Like, and then, yeah, I don't know. I wish to become a god, bro. You're on Dallas and have a cafeteria. Yeah. Yeah, he wasn't about to do shit. Okay, let's see. I did that. I think where do I need to go now? I need to get the, I need to get the cog. Four went through so many iterations. We did get Devil May Cry. Yep, we got the... I still want a Devil May Cry either prequel about Sparta, where Drew Combs comes back to voice Sparta, because he was the OG Dante voice actor, or they do something and he comes back, because, damn it, his voice acting in the first game was so fun. Where do I go from here? Because I did the crank, which apparently it was a one-and-done thing. It's like, yeah, I'm out of here, homie. No more crank for you. Secretary office, second floor. Okay. I could probably go up the little ladder, avoid the zombies, and it's probably on the right, so I might have to fight that damn zombie. You know what? I got an ink ribbon here. I'm going to save first.
Hey, you haven't saved in a while.
Yeah, it's been a hot minute. Just in case I kick the bucket. One of the things I do like about the remake of 2 is they do bring in stuff from RE 1.5, like Mr. X has a hat and shit, and I love that you can shoot it off and he'll be like, oh, he'll get pissed off at you. Yeah, go ahead and grab me. I know. Fuck you.
Dang, that put you into caution already?
I was probably a little hurt from earlier. Although this is normal, so... Smokey! Speaking of Devil May Cry, I cannot wait for the series. Looks amazing so far. Oh yeah, the anime series. It looks like it's going to be good. I'm going to heal up with a regular save the red and green. Ooh, thank you for the hydrate dim bones and the stretch. I'm going to stretch now. Oh, that pops so good. And hold on, I'm going to turn my lamp on because it's getting dark outside. Let's see, it looks better. Yeah, it does look better than the original anime from what I remember the original anime. Time to go get the handgun parts. Let's go.
I am going to run to the restroom real quick.
No.
Okay.
Go ahead, man. No, go ahead. I'll wait for you, man. Go ahead.
I'm gonna explode.
Let's see. God, there's like okay. Quite a few animes that are looking really fucking good. The first ep all. Yep. Alright, Finn's BRB with the bathroom. Why at the end of the year? I know, right? There's a lot of games coming out, and I'm like, oh my god, money is so tight right now. The original anime didn't have one decent fight scene? Damn, that's disappointing. Because with Devil May Cry, you expect good fight scenes. Hold on. ...2024 has been an insane year. It really has. Fun fact, as weird as it sounds, VP-70s actually do work like that. The stock has a mechanism that allows to burst fire. Okay, yeah. We had an episode dedicated to the students of Sparta from Hell, and it didn't have a good fight in it. Well, that's disappointing. I remember hearing about those students. PAL World, the Nintendo lawsuit happening now, the Nintendo leaks, like... four attempted assassinations. Yeah, it's fucking wild, dude. Like, I kind of hope 2024, like... finishes on a good note of some kind. The new series is made by the guy who made the Castlevania series. Nice. Like, I enjoyed the first Castlevania anime. I didn't need to see the newest one, the Nocturne or whatever, but it did look good too. So, you like to play Castlevania? Like, we started out this year. Yeah, this year started out with, like, nothing going on, and all of a sudden, boom, 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 boom. 2024 has certainly been the year of all time. We're gonna save again. Psycho Madness reading my memory card caught me off completely off guard when I was a kid. Yeah, same. Also, Nintendo leaks that it just happened apparently like nuclear level. Like, the dude who's leaked it is not going to survive. What the fuck did he leak? Need to hurry up and become a better year. Yeah, I know, Dim Bones. I'm right there with you. Hey there, Ash Frost. How you doing? I'm also going to, while Finn's AFK, I'm going to check on the streams I'm lurking in, see if anybody is still doing their thing.
I am back.
Welcome back. Okay. Ooh, Ryona's still live. Let me give her some self-care real quick, because it's been a hot minute. She's been playing the hell out of that Metaphor game. I'll have to try that. It looks cool. And my friend here, let me give them some hydration. Stretch. And I'm going to check on Emmy, because she's playing Fortnite. Give her some self-care. She's got, there it is.
The Halloween stuff is actually pretty fun. I'm not going to lie, the chainsaw is OP.
Yeah, it's fun. There's a hydrate for her. I'm trying to find it through her redeems. The chainsaw is fun to use traversally, and it's fun to kill people with, and so, and Leatherface being the skin, it's like, it's funny how much that motherfucker's in shit. Let's see, like, source code, something about the DS Pokemon multiplayer, I think. I didn't see the leaks myself, but apparently it was some huge items. So apparently they stole the source code for Pokemon. Oh, fuck. They leaked the beginning of the Pokemon universe. Oh. Gen 3, Legends of Zelda, Legends ZA, Gen 10, Switch 2, all... Wow, Nintendo got fucked. Yeah, whoever leaked that, Ripperoni and Pepperoni, you're probably fucked, my guy. Or whoever you are. Like, Alexa, play Run to the Hills by Iron Maiden. Run to the hills. I'm gonna open this. Canada Dried Fruit Splash Cherry Ginger Ale here. The hat got a bunch of things. Which, glad about... Not gonna lie, glad about the leaks. Fuck Nintendo, hating Nintendo is always based. As somebody who grew up with Nintendo, loved their products, like, my first gaming memory is five-year-old me at my father's mother's house, because I refused to call her my grandmother, playing the NES on her big-ass TV, and every time Mario would jump, I would jump too. I'm disappointed and saddened that Nintendo just turned out to be just a horrible fucking company. You know, it sucks, because I have so many fond memories with their shit. I'm gonna be a snitch. Doc is live. Oh, Doc is live? I'm surprised. I hadn't heard from her in so long. I messaged her earlier.
Yeah, I see she's live too.
Thank you for letting me know that. Let's see, Nintendo has good games, but the corpo side is almost Disney level. Yeah, that makes sense. Excuse me. Here's the thing, because people get it twisted. You can enjoy Nintendo's games, but always hate the company. Yeah, that's fair. Nintendo's a corporation, not surprised at all. They broke bad. Yeah. It sucks. Corporations are evil. I hate that we have them so much, but, you know. Okay. New save room. New place to go here. We shitting and getting. Don't mind me, I'm just grabbing ammo. Oh my god, oh my god, oh shit. Like, what Nintendo's doing right now is the Pal World lawsuit is a dangerous precedent, because I keep hearing people go, but I don't like Pal World. It isn't like we haven't had years of media telling us how bad corporations are. Yeah. I love a lot of Nintendo games. I just wish they didn't let the corpo side take over, because it fucked them. Mm-hmm. Heart Gold, Soul Silver, Black 2, White 2, Source Codes leaked. Oh. Oh! Oh, hey. I don't have a thingy.
Not yet. You gotta watch it burn.
It burns, burns, burns.
The ring of fire.
Ring of fire.
The ring of fire is what I call my asshole after a night of Taco Bell.
Oh my gosh, shut up. Come on, come on. I gotta corral your ass. Come on. Get juked, idiot! Let's see. She wants them guns. I mean, fair. Let's see. Modding's about to go Super Saiyan for those games. Yeah, and I also, like, love that, like, Sparking Zero, I'm eventually gonna get, the Dragon Ball game. The, mods for it have already just gone crazy. Like, here's one example in MMO, how bad the corporate side fucked them, that one triple bundle of Mario games on the Switch. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When you get so big and effectively a monopoly, the bullshit will come surface. Nutty, hello, how you doing? Yeah, give Soul all your monies. You give Nutty all your monies too. Yeah, Bandit, I think, is asleep. He can join at any time if he wakes up, it's fine. But I know he's probably tired.
He doing the EP.
Yeah. We must wake the bandit. No, he's probably going through so much. It's fine. Here, we're going to save again. Because I made it through here perfectly, and it'll probably never happen again. Oh, shit. I forgot about this. Ah, zombies! Here for a bit because I gotta get ready for uni. Well, I hope university goes well for you, Nutty. It's always a pleasure to see you. Excuse me, pardon me, go fuck yourselves. No. No.
She did a quick turn.
She's like, I want them guns, that ass. Give it to me. Give it to me right meow.
She wants some of that dick.
That yuck. Lady, please, I don't know you. Are you okay?
I almost spit out my water.
It's Misty's sister, Bisty. I'm sorry, I almost made you spit your water out. Yuck. I love how the handgun ammo survived being on fire. Well, I'll take that. Shit. I don't need firepower when I'm rocking these guns.
I got two guns, one for each of you.
Fuck you, 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 fuck, 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 fuck. I hate crows in this game. Okay, do I need the valve still, or can I put it away for now?
You're not gonna need it till you get to the sewer again.
Okay. Alright. Now, I know I probably need to go past the, nom the kaiju.
No, I nom you. Nom.
Nom, nom, nom. Get them gems? Alright. Because I think it isn't the gym room past that zombie.
Yeah, it's past the helicopter.
They really did have a helicopter. I gotta kill this motherfucker, or at least, you know. Oh, yeah, there's two zombies. I don't have any more shotgun ammo. I have enough bullets, though. Freeze, motherfucker! I swear, it feels like I shoot faster and do more damage. Ever, come on. Face me in Mortal Kombat, motherfucker. Oh, he's stuck. In
his best, striker cosplay.
Uh-huh. Jump up to get down. The pose is like Alyssa and Kevin's stance to Billy in Outbreak. Yep. I loved playing as those two in Outbreak. Cause especially, you know, because the abilities. And Mark, the big black dude, the security guy's former, I think, Vietnam vet, he does the horse stance and like just shoots like a madman.
Yeah, we used to poke fun at that. We're like, what is this stance? But that man would always blow heads off.
Yep. No! Tita Jim. There I was. Jim's on my titties. What a moment to raid into. Hello there, Frankris. Get Frecked. Well, thank you for bringing in the Freck, Frankris. How you doing? Sending me some memes. I can't wait to see them. I love me some stupid memes. But hello and welcome, Raiders. For those of you that don't know who I am, my name is Soulstone. You can call me Soul. I'm a sometimes robot PNG tuber, dadbot of the VTuber community, and I'm currently playing some OG RE2 tonight. Joining me tonight, normally it's my friend Bandit, as well as now we have Finn here with us. He's this kick-ass kaiju who's a fantastic friend of mine, and I encourage you to follow him because his name is in the stream title as well as Bandit's. Bandit is still sleeping, probably not feeling good or just really tired. He told us, getting raided again.
Yeah, speech.
Yep, that's fine. Alright, hold on. I will get Frecris real quick, shout out, and then I will do one of these for Gartoon. But hello. Hope y'all must have been streaming together, or it's just fortuitous timing. But it's good to see both of y'all. Thank you so much for raiding. For those who don't know who I am, my name is Soulstone. You can call me Soul. Sometimes Robot PNG Tuber, dadbot of the VTuber community. I'm joined tonight on OGRE2 with my friend Finn here. Y'all both sailing in... Okay, Sea of Thieves. Nice. Good game. I need to play that some more. It's been a minute. If you need to raid and run because of time, that's okay. If you want to stay in lurk, exclamation point lurk, or if you want to chill and chat, there's plenty of cool homies here to chat with, yourselves included now. But I'm happy to see you. I hope y'all had a great stream together. And you're having a wonderful weekend. Yeah. Let's see, Abe the Peanut Babe. Hello and welcome. I love the emotes. Hell yeah. And yes, hello, Gartoon. Frecris, good to see y'all. Thank you for bringing your stream community here and everything.
Yes, join us.
Join us.
We all float down here.
Down here! God, I went mumraw in the bloopers for Thundercats. I want to see your tits, my dear. Thank you for the Snarf, Snarf, shut the fuck up, Snarf. Also, thank you for the clip, George. Wait, is that fucking is that liquor gonna bust through the ceiling?
Not in this playthrough, I don't think. It's only in the second scenarios.
Oh, damn it, there's ink ribbons here. I can't, oh god, I'll have to come back for them because ink ribbons are important. Hey, yo, Titty Jim, yeah, I was over here and I put the first gem in. I said, there I was, you know, gems on my titties. And then I got raided.
Dinosaur. I love your name.
Yep, that's a badass name. Hey, hold on. The save room's right over here. Is that a is that bottle of Jack Daniels going to break through the ceiling? I get it, because I said liquor. That's a good one. Thank you for that. That made me chuckle. Alright, we're going to put the plug in here for now. Dee-dee-dee-dee. I'm going to go back and get the ink ribbons, combine them, and do another save, because I never give a shit about counting saves, because these games will fuck you if you're not careful, so might as well save scum that shit. Save scum. Scum. Die. Getting the Virgil lines out. I need to restream the Devil May Cry games and have homies on. Lady, thank you for the hydrate and the switch. Hold on.
Air.
Air. Whoever. I hate when I occasionally have a really long beard hair that's just like, what the fuck? Ears. Oh, that was she typed it in chat. No, I'm the dragon. I love that Strange was telling me last night I was playing last night or the previous night I was playing Fortnite with him, and he told me this story. He sent me the video. This guy was just like just doing a video, and all of a sudden it's like, oh hey, can I pet your dog? And the owner was just like, yeah, sure. And like, apparently he goes to tell his friends, like, dude, that was Seth Rogen. And it's like, oh shit, you pet Seth Rogen's dog. And it's like, he kind of muffled the he calmed it down. He didn't just straight up just do the whole thing. He was like,
Can I pet your dog?
The cast iron always gets me. I love any time Lady puts in sound effects in the stream, because you know it's going to be a good time. Okay, we saved. I guess I can check out this other room over here.
I've been working on mine, and I've got two that I know you're going to love.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I have to blow it up. My bad. Twitch, you fucking dog. Stop giving me ads for Teacup. I'm sorry about the Twitch ads. Let's see. I keep this. I'm hoping to run into some shotgun shells, and I'm keeping the knife in case I run out of handgun ammo. But knowing my luck, the time I put the shotgun in the inventory box, I'll find some goddamn shotgun shells. I keep getting ads for Reese's peanut butter, but they pour the peanut butter into a high heel. What the fuck?
That's weird.
A little bit. Oh, hey, Dad. Thank you for the hydrate. Appreciate you. How you doing? I have to keep getting 10 limbs and win a win for the XP in Fortnite. Jesus Christ. That's a lot of work, Strange.
Dang.
Thank you for the posture check, too.
Is that a daily quest?
God damn it! Words of Nutty. Fuck off! Oh, it's the Survivor Medals. Doing alright, I'm just working on that Lob Corp video. Nice. Whatever I can do to get the XP, I get that. Come on, Francis, get your fat ass over here. I got shit to do, but you're bothering me. I don't want to waste all my ammo, because I killed these other ones to make it easier, but you're still here. And I would knife you, but the knife in this game apparently is dog shit. Or I wonder, hold on, I'm gonna go in here and come out and see if it resets him to where he starts, and if I could just run to that fucking ladder quick enough. I gotta use the key, I know, to go somewhere and do some things. Just one is a xenomorph, let's go!
Nice.
You want to make it to at least the green fire skins in the battle pass? Mm, yeah. The evidence room? Wait a shit, where is that again? Oh wait, it's down this way, isn't it? Where I went that one time. Oh wait, it's near the dark room? Okay. So we can go through here, I think. And I can also use the small key. Ammo! Ah! Let's see, he's connected to the room where Marvin is. Oh, okay. Yeah. Gun juice. Oh, shit, yeah. Love the running noises. Oh yeah, this is the evidence room, isn't it? Oh shit, this room full of zombies! I wish I had the shotgun or the fucking bow gun like Claire. Let's see, this clown girl just emoted at me with her 21 victory crowns. Don't know if I'm going to win this one, gang. Oh, no. You got this, Strange. Just found some old music from a YouTuber I watched like mad, and I keep finding songs they use, and it makes me so happy, I won't lie. Well, that's good. Okay. I'm probably going to have to kill those zombies and do what I got to do. I have enough handgun ammo. I might take an extra healing item just to be safe, but I know I'm gonna save before trying this bullshit. Take it just in case. Okay, here we go. Get fucked! Blah, blah! Get down! I told you to get down! I love that one zombie moan, like it sounds like a cartoon mummy. Let's see, I just got the Rickroll emote, so I just Rickroll all my kills like an asshat. Oh my god, Ziggy. Okay, I know there's one bastard over here, I think, too. Yeah, I heard you, you bitch tits. Update, I dropped to the too late to the next to start chest and got a hole blown into me. It was Darth Maul, foreshadowing.
Oh no.
Why is work tape music so hard to fucking find? I don't know. Air? What? What is it? What happened? Lady just comes in, airs, and leaves. No stipulations. No. Wait, are you not dead? Is there a fucking another one? You bitch! This reminds me of a candle named Clown Pussy.
Oh my gosh.
Clown Fetish is the name of the... That's still funny. Either way, thank you, Lux. That gave me quite a laugh. The other night, my friends and I capped the loot island, and out of nowhere, a T-800 came running at me with naught but a basic pickaxe. God bless for... He's like, no! No, no! Stay down. I told you to stay down, you dumbass. Okay, do that. Swear to God, if there's one more, you fuckers. Hold on. There's nothing else in here but the film? What?
One of those drawers was supposed to have ammo in it.
I'll double check. I'm gonna go develop this film real quick. At that point, you respect the melee duel. I did. And then drop him immediately after. Yeah. A weird photo to have, you know, in the RPD evidence locker thingy. Alternate timeline Leon. Huh, what's this blue gem for? Tosses it away. Like CSGO knife duel, you gotta make a spec duel. Mm-hmm. And Leon's like, a blue gem? Who uses this shit? What a loser. Hey, hold on. I'm pushing A everywhere. Ooh! Ooh! Let's see, I did find two songs, but God, I hope they last the rest of the section. Well, that's one way to find out. Oh, wait, I'm gonna have to kill Marvin, aren't I? Fuck. Marvin, you're gonna go out in the spectacle. I hope you enjoy this. Oh, hey, there's a candle for trans women. Pumpkin fucker. Oh, my God. Marvin, I'm so sorry. I don't want to do this. The game's gonna make me.
Leon, give me that ass.
Motherfucker got a bite. What?
Oh, yeah,
you ass? There.
Now you has
two precinct keys.
Motherfucker, we're still walking for a minute. Kind of sad Leanne doesn't have a thing where it's like, Marvin, I'll make them pay. Marvin should be all healed up by now. Oh my god, see, he's okay. kill Marvin, then smoke a blunt in his honor. Yeah, I ate that herb, I rolled it up, and let's see. What if the trans woman is the pumpkin? Bum bum bum. Pumpkin. Family photo stand? Possibly a family photo. I almost wish he had some ammo on him. He had a fucking gun. Approving nod. This is... Hooray! Check behind the desk? I don't know if it'll let me go behind it. Yeah, it really won't. He's literally, like, knocked something behind the desk. I don't know. I know that the locker that he was leaning against had some ammo, at least. Let you get behind that one. I mean, I'll try again. Again, the other office. Yeah. Nope. I'm a running and moving and. It's just looking at this. It's like, damn, the door handle is just gone. Like, some bad shit went down here.
Yeah.
I guess it should have asked, it'd been easier just to go back the way I came. Hold on a second. I need to do my thing because we've been at this for a little 2 hours. I need to quote retweet that I'm still alive because Sam suggested that because that kind of helps people see I'm streaming and stuff. And I think it has helped in the past. I saw this RE2R fan art of Leon sitting at his desk in the dark looking sad and the zombies of all his coworkers and Marvin celebrating behind him. It was really awesome. Oh man, that is both awesome and sad as hell. What could have been? What should have happened? Fucking Umbrella and Chief Iron's fucking ass. Thank you for the hydrate. Hold on, I'll do that real quick. Marvin took out all the zombies, but Elliot had to go abandon him. Yeah, apparently in this original timeline that happened, which is sad, because it looks like in the remake, Elliot didn't just abandon Marvin.
Elliot?
Elliot? Elliot!
Elliot?
Alright, hold on. Found the tweet. Quote.
Do it every time his name is mentioned.
Elliot? Which reminds me, because Revy's here. I was hanging out with Revy and Chance, or Champs as I call them, the other day. And, we were playing, like, Revy was playing this game called Monstrum, and Chance and I were hanging out in voice. And the monsters in the game I gave voices to for shits and giggles, and one of them I gave a Jimmy Stewart voice. I was like, oh, yeah, Revy, come here. I got to give you a hug. Come here. Don't run from me. It'll be fine. And one of them was Carl Weezer. She's like, come here. You got to hear about the llamas. And then I think the last one was Kermit. Saying, oh, boy, I sure love killing. Yeah. Oh boy, here I go killing again. Yay! Carl was your favorite. I'm glad to hear that. And then Lady Tho stuff, because she doesn't like the Carl voice, because the Carl voice is, for those of you that don't know, is one of the impressions I do that Lady has considered blurst. They're too good, and she doesn't like them. It's that and Trump and I think one or two other ones. You killed many of Chance's friends. Yep. Every time a rat showed up on the screen, Revy goes, look, Chance, it's your friends. Because Chance is a rat wizard VTuber. Okay. He had to go phone home earlier. I need to use the keys. Should probably go over this place. I got more and more quiet as I said them. Yeah, it was great. Okay, I cleared this area out. Probably go in this room here. Although I know there's Zambos. We have fun here. Yeah. I always have fun here. Your stream, any stream. Anytime I'm blessed enough to get to join friends on or off stream, it's going to be a fun time. I don't get to hang out with a lot of people like I want to. Webedin Evil do. Hey there, Zobby. How you doing? Good to see you, puppy butt. Hope you're doing well. Okay, there's him. I got something for you, sir. Just step a little closer, see? Yeah, just a little closer. Raise your hands, then now you're fucking dead. Yeah.
Just a little off the top.
Just a little bit off the top. Doing pretty good. I'm doing good. Can't complain. Hanging out with a good buddy, playing RE2, having fun. You caught Mothra. Fuck yeah. You caught
what
Pokemon
do you mean,
Mothra.
You caught Mothra.
This is just Volcarona, or whatever its name is. Sorry, madam, you gotta go down.
Oh no.
Okay, hold on. I need water for this. I will read this. Okay. From the moment I understood the weakness of my flesh, it disgusted me. I claimed the strength and certainty of steel. I aspire to the purity of the blessed machine. Your kind claim to your flesh as if it will not decay and fail you. One day, the cooled biomass that you call a temple will wither, and you'll beg my kind to save you. But I am already saved, for the machine is immortal. Even in death, I serve the Omniscia, because he gives me llamas. That's so cursed! I couldn't escape it even though I mean it. I'm sorry, lady. The diamond key is used for, like, what, two doors? That's so ridiculous. You're amazing. I appreciate that. Oh, Elizabeth, I'm coming for you! Oh, hey, Red Herb. That was amazing. Aw, thank you. Oh, wait. Shit. I may have fucked up. Okay. I know the liquor burst through from one side to the other. Hold on. I love that Revy picked the fucking Mechanicus speech. You know, out of all the things to Warhammer, for Carl to say, because I imagine Carl all, you know, Adeptus Mechanicus five, just, you know, you know. The weakness of my flesh, I got rid of it because, you know, I had the diabetes and my ass itched a lot, so I just replaced my ass with, like, a toaster.
I got spider legs now.
I got spider legs. I go really fast. Watch this. I'm fast as fuck, boy. Archmago Sweezer. He's got servitors that look like Sheen going around going, Ultra Lord! Ultra Lord! Okay, I think the liquor pops out as I go past this and grab this. Yep! He has a mechadendrite for his inhaler. Oh my god. Is it? I know I need the wires. Or the cord. I'll come back for the first aid spray. Now that he's dead, I'm safe. Ish.
Ish.
We're gonna do a little bit of backtracking, which is, again, it's Resident Evil. It's expected. I will say I'm kind of proud of myself that we went through the, you know, the first half of RE2 on normal and I beat it, because I was expecting, you know, my skills had deteriorated, but minus a couple deaths, some shenanigans, you know, we've been kicking ass, and I'm so happy and proud. I saw a vid of Carl Weezer singing Jimmy Doesn't... Oh my god. Jimmy doesn't know. I'm doing his mom. Well, hey there, Jimbo. I gotta send you to the Shadow Realm now, bud. I still love that his fucking dad got into a fighting game before he did. Alright, I think I should put the cords away for now, right? Because I'm not near the shutter thing, right?
Yeah, I feel like you could put those away for now.
Alright, that'll give us some inventory space. We got almost all the plugs. Okay. I'll go back for that stuff now. It's not easy being Adeptus Mechanicus. I also, like, I know I bring it up sometimes, but I love how new people that come into the stream, if they're Warhammer fans, they're like, holy shit, it's a Necron. And I'm like, no? Although, the idea of a Necron version of Soul and or Primus would be great as PNGs. Oh, God. Like, Primus would be the fucking really evil, just monstrous ones, and then Soul would just be like, hello. See, I remember another Nick fighting game, and I sort of remember Jimmy being in it, early 2000s. Yeah. I can't remember what it's called either, but I know what you're talking about. Come here, first aid spray. You know, I never saw Necron until you said that just now. Yeah, it's happened a few times. Random people that like Warhammer have asked me if he's based off a Necron or is one. And I'm like, if Soul is a Necron, he would be probably like Trazen, but a lot nicer. Because I hear Trazen is like the closest thing to a nice Necron you'll meet. I saw something where Trazen has decided at some point that he's going to save humanity because the Emperor's, you know, decommissioned, and he's like, nah, I kind of find humanity interesting, so I'm going to be their savior now, lol.
That's wild.
Mm-hmm. I feel like there should be more shit in here than that one small key. Am I losing my mind?
I don't ever remember there being more than just, like, one or two items.
Huh. Trazen's a pretty cool dude. I love that. Trazen's pretty chill. He's pretty cool. He's aight. Okay, we still have the heart key, and we have a small key now. We've searched this area thoroughly, except for that last room, but I think I need the club key to open that. Fucking irons and his bullshit with keys. Reminds me of the TTS episode where the Emperor called him trashy the Oh, I love Emperor's Texas speech so fucking much. I need to rewatch all of it because it was so good. The idea of hooking I just love they hook him up to a Texas speech machine. It's like, oh, finally, I have so much to complain about. And I'm like, alright, we're off to a great start. Okay, yeah, they got cut off because Games Workshop are a bunch of fucking shitheads. Emmy, hello! Oh, hold on. Oh. Had a stretch there. Hello and welcome, Emmy. I hope your Fortnite went well. Thank you for raiding me. How you doing? It's good to see you. Thanks for shouting Emmy out. Hey, meow meow. Good to see you. For those coming in with Emmy, if you don't know who I am, my name is Soulstone. You can call me Soul. Sometimes robot PNG YouTuber, dad bot of the VTuber community. and I'm just playing some OG RE2 with my good buddy next to me here, this fantastic friend of mine, this just badass as all get out kick-ass kaiju here, Finn.
Skreonk.
Skreonk indeed. If you need to lurk, !lurk, if you want to stay in chat, there's plenty of cool people to chat with here, including yourselves now, or if you have to go raid and run because it's late, get some dinner, go sleep, I totally understand that. But I appreciate you kept dropping by and everything. Now, because you did that, I need to find somebody else to chill in their chat and support. Let's see, hold on.
Amy, hello. Meow, meow.
Meow, meow. Thank you for lurking, Revy. I'm late. Well, no, you're not late, Reaper. It's all good. But yes, hello. Hello, Moon. Hello, Emmy. Good to see y'all. Thank you for raiding. Thank you for being here. This is your Moon? Yeah, exactly. Let's see. Got several folks that raided in here and there, and I'm like... Came in with raid, gonna resume lurk. Hope y'all are doing well tonight. Again, Dadbot's all about supporting folks, even while he's streaming. That's just how I roll. Double check here.
I am also lurking in people.
Yeah.
In their chats, I mean, not in people.
Yeah, yeah. Weird. Yeah, it would be very weird. Notification thing. That done. Okay. No, you're in people, Finn. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. All right, first aid spray. I'm gonna put you up. Now I have one shotgun shell and 11 handgun bullets to my name. I need more ammo. Okay. I think a heart door's through here.
Ooh, yeah!
I was waiting on it. I was waiting for it to happen.
Ooh, yeah!
East office? Am I heading towards the east office or I need to go back? Feel free to tell me. I'm in the west wing. Okay, I'm in the wrong fucking section. Go back.
I was sitting there trying to figure out how you remembered the names of the rooms.
Yeah. I wonder if going up the ladder and going to the other side would help too. I know all but one of the zombies up here I fucking murdered. You played this game a lot? That's fair. I'll be shocked if I remember much of RE3, even though I did play the shit out of it as a kid. Like, literally, I remember young me playing it at least 26 times. Like, beating it, everything. Like, I loved it so much. And when my friend Hikari was playing it earlier, I think this year, and let me come along for the ride, it was so nice to revisit the game. I was so happy. I was like, God, I still love this game so much.
Mm-hmm.
I can't help it. Like, the classics are so good to me. They will always be a fun time. Which I wish PlayStation would stop being fucking dickheads and go, hey, here's the original trilogy for you to play on your PlayStation. But they've got it to where, oh, the first one is there if you do PlayStation Premium, which I'm going to probably have to cancel Premium because it's just taking too much money every month. I wish I could keep affording it because it's nice to some degree, but there's so much stuff that I don't play or do. But I'm like, damn it, I hate PlayStation kept doing raising their prices. Thank you for the hydrate.
We need to find you some more ammo.
Yeah. I probably shouldn't have killed so many zombies. bro, when Game Corp stop being brand dead and this market is going to flood with insane drops. Yeah, I hope that happens soon. Wait, I can go through here, I think, and go down the steps. I played my PS1 till it broke. Yeah, relatable. Ooh, green herb.
I still have my PS2. I'm pretty certain it still works, too.
I think my PS2 and PS3 are somewhere back home. I don't know. Oh, man, there's herbs here I can't pick up. Son of a bitch. I'll pick up at least one of them here. I think there's a door here I can unlock with this hard key, like he said, to the basement. Oh, shit. Hold on.
There you go.
Nice catching tentacle there. My PS2 still works as well, but my Dreamcast, I loved it so much. Young me, though, had the misfortune of we had a family dog that was inside dog, and it pissed on the Dreamcast and killed it while I was playing Marvel's Capcom 2. I'm still devastated, and it's been, you know, years.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Ooh, I should probably get get the wires and patch those up first chance I get.
Yeah.
That dogs.
Mm-hmm. Zombie puppers.
Just die. See, like the amount of just easy win ideas that game companies can do and they just don't do for some reason, saying it really is. I'm probably one of the few gamers that would rather get games rooted in PS1, PS2 days than when another 4K AAA. No, Javi, you're among friends here. We all appreciate the older games. It doesn't. I have just as much fun playing this as I would, like, the newest God of War. It doesn't have to be AAA. It doesn't have to be super realistic. I just want a game that has a good story, is fun to play, and is just something I can spend good time with. Give me a Dragon Quest Monster Joker remake. That shit was so fun. That sounds... I never got to play much of the Dragon Quest, but I know I would have liked them. Okay, now there's still another dog. Yeah, it just needs to be fun. That's all it needs. All I want for my video game, to be fun. Stay down, Scooby. Fuck you, what's his, shit. Marmaduke?
Marmaduke.
Okay, let's see. Sorry, he's got to raid and run. No, that's fine, Emmy. Go get some rest. Thank you for raiding. So pissed and Sody says, screw the classic retro games in the PlayStation Store. Yep, I'm miffed about it. I was dragging the beat-up sack of my Sly Cooper games all the way to the damn PS4 subscription-only service. I finally let it go and bought all games on PC. Yep. Sony's... I love, like, the... Was it the head person that Sony's like, we don't have any IPs, so it's not worth it. I'm like... Proceeds to show you the tweets of a bunch of people's talking about IPs that Sony has that they could do. Like I was shocked they're re-releasing the Gex stuff, because I know that makes you happy. And I'm happy, too, because Gex was great. But there's, you know, there's all these IPs, the IPs they're sleeping on. Because they're just fucking stupid.
Yeah. I don't understand. Well, yeah, I do. Corporations just kill me with how brain dead their decision making is. And mm-hmm. none of it is good. They think it's a good idea, but it's really and truthfully all about pleasing their investors.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Still have the urge to go back and play Vex or Scalar on my PS2. Hell yeah. Let's see. Now here's the thing. Don't change a fucking thing about the game. Literally just give it a re-release. Yeah, honestly. I'll come back for you. Okay, before I go to the parking lot and I think meet Ada, let me do some stuff real quick. Just glad I had enough bullets to kill them fucking dogs.
Mm-hmm.
I want to go get the cord and do this shit, because I think it'll last, you know, before the zombie invasion, right?
I think that happens later.
That'd be good to just do it now, right?
Yeah, if you have it.
Let's see, I just want the MCC treatment for my favorite game series, like Killzone, Ratchet & Clank, and the Greek God of War. I mean, that's totally fair. Games like Star Wars Battlefront 4 or RE2 Driver are better than the majority of games released nowadays, honestly. Mm-hmm. It's funny, the Star Wars thing reminded me, they're re-releasing fucking Jedi Power Battle, which I'm excited for, because I love that game.
Wait, what?
Yeah, they had a trailer the other day. They're releasing the Power Battle where you can play, you know, through episode 1. It's like Qui-Gon, Plo Koon, Mace Windu, you know, all that shit.
I remember that game. I used to have it.
I used to love the shit out of it. People were like, ah, the Dark Souls of my youth. That's all one comment said. It was really fucking hard.
Yeah.
To this day, nothing is harder than Winnie the Pooh's Home Run Derby. Fuck that game. Yeah, I remember that game. Remember all the YouTubers and everything playing it. It was like, what the fuck? True. Oh, shit. God, I need ammo. But at least, hey, we're okay. I'm gonna go back, put the cord in, and go down the basement, do what we need to do. Fuck you, Piglet. Wait, no, other way. Shit. Fucking crows. I was stuck on Piglet for a month. I love that. Just fuck you, Piglet. Piglet's like, oh, deer. Like, oh, deer, nothing. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up, Piglet.
Snivelly weasel looking little bitch.
Well, I felt bad for Piglet. He was just, he's like a little scared little shit. Like, I love Eeyore, just, it's just always just like, I'm gonna do it. Okay.
Peter Cullen.
And Greg Berger. Eeyore has the distinctive honor to have been voiced by Optimus Prime and Eeyore, which is pretty goated. Then you get Christopher Robin and Tigger. Oh God, Eeyore's my spirit animal. Eeyore is delightful and deserves all the good things to happen to him. Shoddy shells, hell yeah! I'm glad I found them now, because I would have wasted them on the dogs. Okay, that's shut for now. often been described as Eeyore. I've been compared to Eeyore as well. I take it as a compliment. Because Eeyore's been smoking that good weed. Yep. I'm going to get these green herbs and put them up too. Battlefront 4, what timeline are you from and where can I go there? Piglet can fuck off after Home Run Derby. I don't give a crap about this. I was not expecting Piglet hate in my stream chat today. Said, fuck Piglet. Hate that little bastard. I wanted that Battlefront 3 that Pandemic was making. Oh, yeah. I think I remember hearing about that. Hell, I wanted that Star Wars Bounty Hunter game we were going to get. And then they just said, nah, fuck it. You don't deserve it. Oh, yeah, fuck. I got sidetracked nerding out with y'all. I need to go put these herbs up. Me, a Piglet fan, because I only watch the movies and never play the games. Oh, no, CC, it's okay. It's okay. Piglet's wonderful. Fuck you, Disney. We also robbed. Yeah, that Darth Maul game would have been goated. I guarantee you everybody here has some gripes with Disney about the stuff they've done, especially with Star Wars and Marvel. Like, recent Marvel shit got me upset finding out that they're like, oh, we're going to introduce Doctor Doom to make Ben happy, but we're going to make it to where him and Reed don't have a history together or hate each other. And I'm like, well, then what's the fucking point? What's the point? Get the fuck out of here with that bullshit. I can't watch Winnie the Pooh without crying, like that guy crying when he smoked weed. Oh my God. I watched Piglet's Big Movie over and over when I was pregnant, but yeah, Disney's a company as a fuck. Yeah, again, like we've established, we can appreciate the product, but the company can eat a bag of dicks. That's just how it is. Okay, hold on. I gotta organize my inventory, y'all bear with me. We're sorting things to where. There we go. I like to have some you know, kind of framework, if you will. Let's see, Darth Maul game wasn't going to happen, and that's a tragedy. Childhood memories, the product is fine for the most part. The company sucks. Never forget that two gay cops that couldn't say they were gay. Is that... That's in Gravity Falls, right? Which, yeah, that was all but, you know, confirmed, and that's so stupid. You know, Disney... Yeah, because Deputy Blubbs and... Sheriff Blubbs and Deputy Derlin... It's obvious it was there, and they were just a happy couple of situation, and it's so stupid that Disney is, I love their whole, oh, hey, our movies aren't doing great, it must be because of the gays. It's like, no, you dumbasses.
Yeah, for
real. Representation is fine, your scripts and everything are just sucking dog shit. People watch Rooster Teeth rage at Winnie the Pooh's home run. Yep, I remember Michael raging at it. Imagine that, but with worse swearing and tears that will be for a year. Jesus Christ. I'm so sorry, Javi. Hot damn. They were so fun and gay. They were. Every gay film has done better than every straight film. Pretty much, honestly. Okay. Oh yeah, you're in here. Hold on. Good old rage quit Michael. He still has elements of it, but he's calmer. Yeah, having two kids or however many kids with Lindsay chilled him the fuck out. It's still weird that Ruby Rose is a VTuber now.
Wait, what?
Yeah, because you know Rooster Teeth died, but they saved Ruby and Ruby herself is a VTuber now.
That's wild.
Yep. Not a whole bad thing, but I'm just sitting here like... Because she has moments where she's the character, but then she's also playing these games and collabing with folks and stuff. Teaches you patience even then. I've always heard he was a chill dude. Yeah. Oh, what were you going to say? I'm sorry.
I was just going to say, I know Casey and Matt were pretty devastated over the whole Rooster Teeth collapsing.
Well, I know. Yeah.
I know a lot of the people that streamed there or played games, they kind of got quote-unquote saved
sorry by
other
about
places.
Mm-hmm. When I saw the uniform, I thought
the
you
D&D
were another
show
zombie.
That Gus started, Stinky Dragon, Critical
Who
Role
are you?
Adopted them.
Okay.
Ada Wong.
That
and
stare.
What are you doing here?
I'm looking for some guy named Ben. He's one of those
some
reporter
guy.
Types.
Hey, Opie.
He's looking for a scoop. I heard he was locked Opie. Up in the cell block, only there's a red car barring the entrance.
Just throwing shit at me.
Find another way inside.
God, all the shit just hitting me.
If we work together, we can
Ada with that John Connor cut. Hold on. I'm opening up these. Oh my god. Oh god.
Was that a bird that just flew by?
Yeah, Ribby. Yeah, you're right. Also, alright, y'all get it out of your system. I'm just glad it's missing Finn hitting me.
No. No.
No. No. You're trying to catch someone. It's like WCW the 90s all over again. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Jeez.
I'm waiting for the iCast iron. It got caught up in all the heads ups. We're trying to feed Finn. Oh, okay. Hold on. Let me, Oh, my mouse won't let me do anything. I was going to, like, move Finn to where...